The wall seems to be sturdy, and there's enough space between you and the door to maybe like climb up it, but not very much to do much else.
I don't suppose we could walk around the wall.
You could try walking around the wall. It's very narrow, but you could squeeze through.
Or, oh, I don't know if you heard that, all that. Laura's gonna scooch past the wall.
Okay. You're able to scooch past the wall.
Well, that was easy.
Mm-hmm. Some things
Am I
are.
Am I about to get murdered?
I don't know.
Monster.
You're on the other side of the wall. You see a hallway.
Cool.
What's over there?
So I see there's a hallway. I don't see anything too interesting in this room.
You sound so weird. Are you sure you're not, like, under a spell? It's echoey. Maybe the ceiling's really high.
Of course not, fellow humans. I'm not under a spell. Why would I be?
Oh, did it sound like it was going through both of our mics? I was trying to sound distancy.
It sounded cool. We could understand what you were saying. I was just thinking
okay.
Silly. Oh, no.
Oh, whoops, I just moved her inside a wall. Laura's gonna just look ahead, and then she's gonna report back.
Alright, so you run back to your friends. So this side of the hallway, you see a larger chamber that opens up. It's just kind of like an opening in the middle of this hallway. There seems to be something on the ceiling up ahead, but it's hard to see from where you are.
I see. Okay, so Laura knows nothing about dungeons.
Okay.
However, let's see. I'm gonna. Oh gosh, do I have water? I totally have water in my water skin. Okay, I'm going to take some water out of my water skin and then use shape water to like make a ball of water and like bring that up to the ceiling.
Okay.
In case there's like a bat or something, so I can disturb it.
So you take the shape water and you bring it up to the ceiling. Up on the ceiling, nothing seems to move. There seems to be like a circle on the ceiling that is a different color than the rest of the ceiling. It's not too hard to see. It looks like some sort of trap door, maybe.
Okay, I'm gonna stop. I'm gonna drop the water, and then I'm gonna report back to my friends.
Okay.
Yeah, so there's something on the ceiling in a big room. It's probably dangerous, but I don't want to play with it alone.
Good luck! Which way did you go?
I just went south. Well, sorry, I went that way.
All right, oh, and of let's course, go. Yeah.
Okay, so you move through the hallway. You get to the larger chamber.
Who's gonna go in first?
Seabolt!
Somebody who's strong.
Seabolt is brave.
Or maybe a bear. Just kidding, this hallway is really small.
you could make a small bear and then.
What? If you're gonna be a bear. Be a bear. Don't be a small bear. Come on,
be a big bear.
You could be a teddy bear.
Oh, so snuggly.
Can you turn into a teddy bear?
Can you turn into a teddy bear?
I mean,
asking the important question.
You know, that type of animal, the teddy bear.
The most dangerous, but the most dangerous foe.
I think technically that's a grizzly bear. I don't remember.
Yes, it was a grizzly bear that Theodore Roosevelt killed.
No, he didn't kill.
Oh, it's a bear that he didn't kill. Yes, he was gonna kill it, but he didn't. And it's called the teddy bear because it's Theodore Roosevelt.
Oh, but he killed like everything else. But that's cool.
Yeah,
he didn't kill it because it was like a baby bear, and it was like tied up, and he was like, "Well, there's no sport in this."
Okay, so
he let it live.
So what do you all want to do with this hallway? It's, you know, pretty standard for the hallways in this dungeon. Stuccoed walls, tile floor. There's that circle on the ceiling with a handle on it. There's a latch holding it closed.
Okay, I have an idea. I'm just going to run through really quickly. And if everyone's okay with that, and see if something drops down.
Okay. You run across. There, nothing.
She takes the dash action.
Nothing seems to happen.
Well, I guess we should be fine. What's up there?
Is it a hatch?
It looks like some sort of hatch, yeah.
Maybe we should open it. Maybe it's a way out.
That's a good point.
Is there any way to perceive if there's like any kind of sunlight peering through? Is it sealed shut?
It's definitely sealed shut, so it's airtight.
Okay.
You can't tell if there's light on the other side.
So is anybody good? Oh, you know who's good with thieves' tools? With
dying.
That one guy that's dying. This is a good one.
Can we like hear anything through it?
You don't hear anything through it, no. Make a perception check if you're kind of trying to examine it. And anybody can do that.
Let me see how much flying I have left.
Since you've all been kind of asking questions about that.
I mean, it's pretty high up, right? I'm just gonna stare at it and try to hear things real hard. Just gonna like screw up her face and like put her hands around her ears.
Okay. So, you know, it's okay. So you can't hear anything, Manny. Laura's investigation check, I'm assuming, is kind of a different thing. So what are you investigating, Laura?
I want to investigate the thing. The hatch.
Okay.
Actually, hey, Deglin, would you mind if I borrow your lockpick? Actually, have we tried to open it? That's important to check.
Does it open down or out?
It opens down, and there's these rings. Oh, this is an important detail. There are rings all over the walls, like handholds, that kind of form a ladder that would let you climb up there. So the whole room is covered in these rings all over the walls.
That seems...
How tall is the room?
A swimmy situation.
How tall is the room? The room appears to be 15 feet high. So you have people that can fly, you know, but other than that...
I can cast fly.
Sure.
Benjamin, would you mind picking me up?
If you wish, yes.
And then I can try and pull down the thing.
Sure, we can do that.
What if like a bunch of snakes fall through and then try to eat us?
Okay, so y'all be not in this room. And just Ben and I will be in the room.
I'm gonna go over here.
Okay. You know, because I don't want to waste that 20 that you rolled, Laura, one thing I'll point out to you, since you've been kind of asking questions and looking at stuff, is it looks like there is some discoloration on one of the walls near where you were just standing, by where Manny is standing right now.
Interesting.
And it appears to be a secret door of some kind, at least from what you've seen in here.
How interesting. I've used my investigative skills to... Hey, what's that over there on the wall? Okay, then you can put me down now.
No, you don't want to open the hatch anymore?
Look, it's a door. Doors are much easier to open than hatches.
Okay.
Plus, you know, snakes usually don't come out of doors.
Okay. Well, the door... So if you're opening the door... It
and
leads...
And then a catapult, ballista, snakes.
You're firing snakes?
No.
I'm just kind of peeking around the corner, but the idea will be... I don't think I can, like, ready a shot because I don't know what'll fall, and I don't want to injure something if it's not supposed to be injured, so I'm just keeping an eye from around the corner.
Yeah, there, as you can see, there appears to be another door back there.
Yeah, so there's like a door. Is it look pretty similar to every other door?
It does, yeah. It seems to be fairly similar.
I'm gonna open the... Wait, what's with this?
By the way, after you went in, the door did close behind you. It kind of just swings shut on its own.
That's interesting.
Oh.
Oh no! I'm gonna try to push it and see if it'll open.
It does seem to open back up.
Okay, phew.
Is there a handle on the back that I could grab?
No, there's no handle. In fact, to get into it, you pressed into, like, a stone that was sticking out on the wall. And that kind of opened it temporarily, and then it swung shut behind you.
Okay, well, you guys probably can't hear me very well, but I don't really know how I would get out other than with Manny's help. So I'm gonna explore further, since I'm the main character or something.
Okay.
You're
since here. I'm the main character or something, that's the final last words.
So are you opening that door?
Yeah. Also, Claire says she has to make a phone call.
Okay. Well, a lot of people have to do that. There is another chamber
in
here.
Okay, these are circles. I'm going to go back out.
Okay. These are circles.
Okay. I'd rather have you guys here. It's... Manny, can you hear me?
A little bit. You're really, really quiet. Like, I don't know. If I put my ear up to the door, you're fine.
And actually, you can open the door from this side, too.
This is
more fun because it's like secrets.
Yeah, you realize that you can open the door from the side that you're on as well. There's another stone projection.
Oh, I found a way out. So it looks like there's some kind of a magic circle in that room.
Like a teleportation circle?
I'm not sure.
Or like something drawn on the ground? Or like inlaid in the...
Okay, have you ever looked at Elrod's spell books? There's always these like these shapes. And like one of them was a magic circle in it. Had also magic triangles exist too, and those were used for spells or something, and I think it's one of those.
Okay. Maybe it's everything. Maybe it's a way out. I don't know. What do you guys think?
I don't.
You don't think anything.
Well, what's over here? What's this? I don't know.
We should open the trap door. It's a mystery.
Okay.
Okay, so are you opening the trapdoor? Are you standing on each other's shoulders or using the rings to get up?
I'm gonna climb up on the wall just that feels like it's safe. Oh no, but I'm probably really bad at climbing.
All right. Are
well,
you?
That's not a skill in this game. Haha.
Climbing would normally be like athletics, but you don't have to with your with the rings. It's fairly easy.
Okay.
Are you unlatching the door?
I don't have that ability. It's like locked and stuff.
No, it's not locked. There's just like a latch over the trapdoor.
Sure, we want to do this?
Sure! I face death on a daily basis.
I don't think I want to listen to you. No offense. You're like hardly ever here, and you like go invisible and take eggs and things.
Don't take eggs. What egg? What are you talking about?
I don't know.
I only serve the Allfather. What are you talking about?
And she'll open the hatch very reluctantly, and then she'll like scurry back to the wall as quickly as she can.
Okay, well, you open the hatch, and before much scurrying happens, you hear that sound of like a hand dryer in a bathroom, like a zzzz, and a vortex of air.
Oh shit!
A vortex of air sucks down from the hole in the ceiling, you all begin spinning around in circles, those of you kind of within this area, so the four of you. You're spinning in circles and circles. Everybody make a strength saving throw. Manny, you can have advantage because you were hanging on to the rungs.
Okay.
Whoops.
Does that include Cobalt?
Seabolt is in the vortex, yes.
Am I in the vortex?
No, you're, like as far you as I can tell, you're in the hallway, unless you should have been somewhere else, but...
Well, I was all the way over there the entire time. In the corner.
Maeve's player is not in the room right now. So I'm just gonna... Also, she might be just... I don't know, is Claire in the... No, she's Kraptos muted.
Yeah, she's stuff. Okay, so you are all just getting wrecked in here.
At first, it's really fun, and she like does cartwheels, and then she's like, "Oh God, I'm
so
gonna be sick."
Everybody is going to take a little bit of damage here. So you all take one damage for getting just bustled about the room. And then Ben and Emmy and Maeve all get drugged. Like, you get snagged on the broken, rusty rungs in the room. So... One damage for everybody, and two for Ben, Emmy, and Claire. Okay.
So that would be Seibold.
Oh, Seibold. Yes, my bad. So, you're still stuck in this vortex. You can't seem to get out. The wind is tossing you around.
Laura's going to use a spell. She's going to cast a spell. She's going to cast... Gust, and she's gonna get Maeve. She's gonna push Maeve out.
Okay, you push Maeve out of the room with Gust. Whoosh.
She's... To be fair, I'm not sure if that's actually like allowed, but
I don't think it is. So I don't know how, but there's no, with those cantrips or, you know, there's nothing I can really do. Like, I don't want to kill everyone's creativity, but at the same time, like, what am I going to do about it? I've got no rules to back anything up. So Maeve is, let's see, actually what we'll do is we'll give Maeve advantage on her throw. So let's go ahead and roll for initiative.
Oh no.
Oh no, the zero.
Everybody's just rolling real good. I'm really into the rolls.
Two for Seabolt in a row.
I don't know if I should be like rolling for Maeve or something.
You can roll for Maeve, or I can roll for Maeve. Here, I'll do it. There we go. Okay. So, oh, just give me one sec here. My turn tracker is, oh no, there it is. Descending. Okay. So Declan, your friends are caught in this vortex. It's loud. It's very scary. And to get over to them, you might find yourself trapped in the same vortex. What do you do?
I think my plan is to go forward and take my rope and tie it around Laura's waist.
Okay.
And then go back around the wall.
Okay. You are anchored. Laura, it's your turn.
Okay. Okay. This is a plan. Now she can... Laura's gonna move into the thing, and now she's going to use Gust to create a small blast... Oh, wait. She creates a blast. It says that she seizes the air and compels it to create one of the following effects. An effect that it chooses to move someone of like a medium, say, whatever, 5 feet away.
Okay.
So I feel like maybe if I'm in the vortex, it doesn't seem unreasonable for her to be able to do that.
Okay. Make a dexterity saving throw, because even though you're anchored, there are people flying all around. Okay, you dodge out of the way of a flying Benjamin as he passes you by, and you push Maeve out of the hall, or out of the vortex, and now you're kind of in here with them, and you're being tugged at. Maeve is out of the room. I don't know what she would normally do in this case. So I would assume that if I can't think of what she would do to help you, I'm going to have her move away. Ed, what do you want to do?
I'm going to stay where I am because I have literally nothing to help.
Okay, so you're staying there watching in horror or amusement as your friends...
I'm probably just playing on my...
on your smartphone?
Yeah, just like, you know, they got this. They're fine. Just playing some more Asmodeus went down to Bilgewater.
Okay, so you're playing a dirge while your friends are being tussled about, and it's Seabolt's turn. Seabolt needs to make a strength saving throw.
All right. I don't think I coped it. Oh gosh. Well.
Okay. So Seabolt is going to take D6. One damage for bashing against the wall, and three damage for the rusty spikes that are part of the broken handles.
Okay. Is he able to try to act, or is that just the...
He is going to try to act if you would like. What would you like Seabolt to do? He can attempt to try to figure a way out of here.
Is he able to grab onto Laura?
He can.
Use her as an anchor?
Yeah, he's going to need to make a dexterity saving throw. Okay.
This is going to be enough strength that Deadwing can handle.
He does latch on to Laura, but he, you know, slams into her first, and she takes one damage. So you're now embracing Seabolt, and it is Menny's turn.
So the air is like blowing out of the hatch, or
it's like a cyclone dipped down through the hatch and is just spinning in a circle from floor to ceiling.
I mean, if I can try to like grab onto the hatch and
try to close it. So it appears that the hatch is just stuck open. Like it's the force of the wind would probably be too strong. Like you're reaching up and you're trying to close it, but the air is just too much to close the hatch. But I'll still let you act if you'd like.
Like do something else?
Yeah. You can try to move. You know,
I'll try to like grab onto the handhold on the wall and like, pull myself towards the far.
So the movement cost here is 3 feet of speed to move 1 foot in the room. So with your 25-foot speed, you can move roughly like to the edge of the room, I think you can move out. You would need to make a strength saving throw.
Oh no. Can I do acrobatics and stuff?
No.
Nope. Not acrobatics. No, athletics.
Normally you start with a strength saving throw. I just want to make sure you're able to move.
Nope.
Okay. You take 4 damage bludgeoning and 4 damage piercing, and you are tossed, let's say over here. And it is Ben's turn.
Can I try to push, like, I'm still flying around, right?
Well, you're trying to. You're getting kind of sucked around.
Can I use my action to try to push off of a wall?
Yeah, strength save. Okay, yeah, you're able to push off of a wall and you can move at, I guess it's like, it's basically half speed. Or something. I can't understand exactly.
It would be a third speed.
Yeah. So you can move a third of your speed. So you may be able to make it out.
To be 10 feet.
Third of 50 is 15. Yeah? I can go west, right?
Yeah, so you can go towards Declan. Just even pull on the rope. Declan's kind of like, ah! Okay.
I'll get my way over.
And it's Declan's turn.
Yeah, I think, so if I move to here, can I see if Ben is currently still being affected by the wind?
Ben does not seem to be affected by the wind. It seems to end on, like, right at the edge of this room. So, like, this square is affected somewhat, but otherwise, you know, once he got out of it, he was fine.
All right, I'm going to tell him to grab onto the rope, and then we're going to pull.
Okay, so you're pulling the rope, and you're make a strength or athletics check with advantage. Okay. Both of you working together are able to pull both Laura and Seabolt out of the room, and they're now standing there. Oops, like there. Okay. Laura, what do you want to do?
But we left Maeve behind and Menny.
You still have the rope on you. Go get him.
Okay. She's gonna move through Seabolt.
Okay.
And try to
make a dexterity save.
Right. Oh no.
Okay, many also make a dexterity saving throw. Okay. Each of you takes 6 damage. And many is still flying around the room. Maeve, it's your turn.
Maeve is
still on the phone?
Claire's on the phone, yeah.
Okay. Sort of. Unless I'm almost back at my computer.
Back somehow without me hearing because I
got
it. Muted.
Got it. Okay. Well, if you don't have any actions, Ed, it would be your turn. Are you still playing your song?
I just realized that I have to figure out how to get through the room. But, yeah, I don't know. Let me see something.
Do you want to examine, like, what your options are? Like, examine the room?
Yeah.
Okay. So the room is 15 feet wide. It's got a corrugated floor. The ceiling has that bronze trapdoor. And there are rings along the walls as well. So those are kind of your options for movement.
Does it appear that the trapdoor, I know I believe someone attempted, but could it be closed?
It not by normal means.
Okay, so Mage Hand door is out of the question.
Yeah.
What else do I have? This would be the one time when actually going there was a new spell from Xanthar's Guide.
Claire's back.
Unless you remove all winds.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Yeah, I have nothing to actually get through the doorway. So, I'm just going to use Thaumaturgy and just play the song louder.
Okay. The hallway, you're drowning out the sound of the wind with the sound of your rockin' tunes. Seabolt can go.
Seabolt doesn't really have anything that he can contribute with.
I see. Well.
He can pull on the rope too.
Laura went in to try and get
Benny
because she's got a rope.
Okay.
What did you say, Irish?
Just that Seabolt could get ready to pull the rope.
Oh yes, he's gonna get ready to pull the rope once Laura has a hold of Benny. Yes.
Got it.
Not Maeve.
Okay. So everybody's got the rope. Manny, it's your turn. You can try to grab on to Laura if you want to, or you can climb out on your own.
I'll try to grab onto Laura.
Okay, make a dexterity saving throw.
Oh no.
Okay, Laura, go ahead and make a dexterity saving throw.
That's just gonna kill me.
God!
Okay, that is not beautiful assistant actually making the save, for the record.
Sure. Well, neither of you got acceptable rolls to do anything, so you both take 6 damage, and you're still flying around. Ben, it's your turn.
Man, that's some good stuff happening. Let's see here. Can I take this, like, quarter staff and, like,
try to reach it out to someone to grab onto?
Sure. Go ahead and reach it out. Manny, go ahead and make an acrobatics check.
Oh, was that the wind thing, or was that Manny's turn that got Laura taking damage?
That was Manny's turn. That was her bumping into you. I didn't give her the extra damage for just like getting bashed on the walls because she was aiming for you, but that's what caused the damage to both of you. So, there's pros and cons there. So Manny is just, she almost like gets it. I gave her advantage because you were helping Ben, but it wasn't quite enough to grab onto that stick.
Just leave me here.
Declan, it's your turn. All of you guys have funny saves.
I really don't think there's much else I can do here.
It happens. Are you... Yeah, I mean, if you're just gonna chill there, that's no big deal.
Well, I mean, I don't think I can do anything. So, I guess I just get ready to pull.
Alright. You're ready to pull, and it is Laura's turn. Laura, do you want to make another catch attempt?
She is going to wait until she is, she's going to wait until there's sort of a line where Manny is over here,
okay.
And she and Laura's over here,
okay.
And she's going to try to use the push. If
okay.
That's all right.
Well, Manny is going to need to make her strength save in order to get to where she wants to be, so it kind of counts on that. So just keep that in mind. Okay.
Okay. In that case, Laura, I didn't know how fast we're cycling, I guess.
You're cycling so fast that I'm not, like, just moving you around every turn. I just imagine, though, that to maintain control of where she is, because, like, I can't give you a skill check to aim or, like, to time yourself to when she's going to be where she wants to be, right? Because it's a cantrip without an attack roll. So it like for the skill it would take to like wait for the right time and push her, I don't have a way of adding any chance to that. So the only chance I have is to have Manny make a strength save. So I don't know what else to do there.
Yeah, that makes sense. Laura's going to grab on. I don't remember what the button is to do that. Or what the skill is. Was it a strength save?
You don't have to make a strength save because you're anchored, so you're not getting bashed against the walls. Like, they're all holding you kind of in the center of the room. So, is that what you're talking about, or what are you doing?
Yeah.
Okay.
She wants to take Benny's. She wants to grab Benny's.
Oh, that's a dexterity save. Okay, you are able to grab Manny, and
arms around Manny.
Yeah, she's grabbed.
Bloodied.
And Maeve, it's your turn.
Can we use that held action to pull?
Oh yeah, I didn't realize that was a held action. Of course, so you can pull them out, and I'm assuming that they are just kind of climbing on through you or on top of you, just kind of all around there. All right, Maeve, it's your turn, and we can be. I guess we're not out of initiative yet, but we kind of are. It's, you know, just don't get sucked into the whirlwind.
So we like this. Yeah. It's, you know, it's tough. There's not a whole lot that a little Maeve can do.
Do you think this is like a symmetrical space?
It's definitely worth
checking.
Like,
maybe there's a way we could get around back to where we were.
Yeah, make a
hallway on the left or something.
Is there an opening?
Make a everybody make perception checks. Okay.
Maybe there was a thing in that secret door.
So
the secret door behind the secret door.
So, Ed, you're closest, so I'll give this one to you. You're like, I'll do it. And you're looking around, and you notice that there is actually another stone sticking out. So there's another, basically secret door that matches the other one.
I go through the secret door.
Okay. You're in a little tiny nook. And Maeve, it's still kind of your turn too, so you can also follow or go as far as you want there.
Yeah, you know, I'll just go on back here and see where life takes me.
Okay. Seabolt, we'll just stay in initiative for now. Seabolt, what do you want to do?
Where the heck did Seabolt go?
He's buried underneath the tokens.
He's under Laura.
Seabolt is just gonna make space.
Okay. So Seabolt is out of the way. And Manny, did you want to do anything?
I'm gonna drink a healing potion.
Alright, you drink a potion of healing.
What are they, 2d4, 2d6?
2d4
plus 2.
4
plus 2, yeah.
Okay. 8 HP is back to you. Ben.
I'm going to try to trudge along the hallway some more while looking for traps.
Got it. Okay. And let me see here. Declan, are you going to go any which way?
I'm just going to untie my rope and then make sure that everybody catches up.
Got it.
Just going to kind of keep an eye out to make sure everybody can make it.
Got it. Okay. Laura, what are you doing?
Laura's going to pick up her small gnome friend, and she's like in tears, like, don't ever scare me like that again.
Aww.
Well, I'm never going first again. Never, ever, ever. I'm just going to follow you guys and try to be helpful.
What you did, Asmodeus's work. Good job.
Asmodeus does not seem like a good guy. I think I don't like him.
Also, lots of the hugs without permission from Laura.
Many hugs back.
Also, gonna move this way.
All right, so you move that way. Maeve, we're back to you.
Is this like a path? Can I go through here?
There's a door right next to Ed, right here.
Oh, okay. Let's go through it. Okay. Assuming it's unlocked.
Yeah, it is. Oh my gosh. Sorry, ignore the acid. Yeah, you're through it. I was just trying to move the dynamic lighting.
Oh.
So
pretty.
The walls of this chamber are flat black, while the floor is inlaid with a colorful mosaic of a strange god that is cavorting and leaping around a sun. There is an alcove in the center of the wall to the in the back there that is covered by a curtain. Ignore that again. Anything else either of you want to do?
I mean, I want to. Is this a mural? Did you say? Or
yeah, there's a mural on the ground here, okay. And there is a curtain back here.
I'm gonna examine the mural and let Ed pull the curtain.
Okay.
You're gonna stand back here and use Mage Hand to pull back the curtain.
Okay. The mural. It seems to represent a some sort of wolf or dog or something like that, and it seems to be dancing around the sun. Make a religion check if you want.
Oh boy.
If you want. Yeah, it's hard to say.
Religion check. One second.
Yeah, it's hard to say. It's just goofy mumbo jumbo. Okay, so Ed, you move the curtain with your mage hand. Behind it, there is a statue that's seated on a throne with a surface that's carved to depict feathers. It's a man, and it's wearing a, it's kind of like an androgynous person that's wearing the head of some sort of dog creature, as like a hat, you know? So it's kind of like a hat that's formed out of a dog creature's head. And lying across its lap in its open palms, is a scepter made of gold and silver, with a raven's head crafted on one end. And then there's like a raven's talon on the other.
Ooh.
The weird thing about the statue, though, isn't that. It's that the statue seems to resemble you.
Me?
I would actually say Ed.
Oh.
It looks like me.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Wow.
I'm a guy. I should go over there and sit on that chair.
All right.
I'm not going to, but I'm just going. I'm just saying that I should.
So neither of you are doing anything else?
I mean, I'm going to look like over here and it's like, oh, hey, a door. I'm just going to look around the rest of the room, I guess.
Okay.
Not going to fuck with the statue yet. We've had bad luck with statues. Statues exactly. Are a common source of death.
So you are wandering around. There doesn't seem to be anything else. So I'm going to go back to the other players. Seabolt.
So once again, I'm not really sure what Seabolt should be doing.
That happens. It's okay.
So he's going to follow the group.
All right. So you're following the group. They're going towards the trap hallway that you're going to go into. It's a trap. So watch out for the trap.
What?
I didn't say anything. Anyway. Okay. Manny, what do you want to do?
They've been gone a long time. Should we, maybe try to find them?
Yes.
Nah, it's fine.
I'm gonna, kind of grab Seabolt and kind of push him towards Laura and Manny. Go in the room and take a look.
I don't want to go first.
And I'm grabbing Seabolt and pushing him towards you guys.
Nobody else go first.
Go ahead.
I'll do it, he says.
Atta boy.
Obviously, Laura is totally unwilling to go into that room.
Okay. So
it's not until Manny goes in.
Everybody goes into the room.
We're just holding hands and freaking out.
I found them.
Good job. Did it.
All right, you're all in the room. You notice the statue has Ed's face. It's holding a scepter. Other than that, there's not much else going on.
Did Ed get turned into stone?
I'm in the corner.
I actually don't see you.
Exactly.
You're probably hidden line of sight-wise. I'm just going to assume it. You got turned into stone. How do we fix him? He had like a bracelet that could fix people who are turned into stone, right?
Oh, it's a colorless energy. It's a normal type. I think I say that every time I see those statues.
Yeah. I guess I'll... Oh, she's not going to want to go forward. She's just going to sit here and wait for other people to do stuff. Because she's so freaked out.
Okay.
Don't touch anything, Maeve. I'm serious. If you touch anything in this room, I will not make you bacon.
So, do we see any sign of this thing that we're looking for and or a way out?
No, there doesn't appear to be any sign of the thing you're looking for. I mean, there's the way you came from, but that's basically it. The vortex is still spinning in that little chamber, which is annoying.
Yeah, there doesn't seem to be anything in this room that indicates it's any sort of an entrance or storage vault or anything like that.
Nothing yet, no.
Do I recognize anything in the mosaic in the floor?
Make a religion check.
I'm not good at that.
Okay. It seems to resemble a coyote, and you've heard that there's like a being that was, you know, like there's all sorts of creation myths in Faerun. Like people say things happen this way and that way, but you know, there's these legends from different tribes about a god that kind of transcends dimensions or time and seems to just cause trouble wherever it goes. This would be coyote.
Transcending time and stuff.
That's right.
Time and space seems like it could be useful, but trouble is no good. Little wily
thing. So tricky. Bonds across time and space.
You said the statue is holding something?
It is. It's holding a scepter.
Maybe the scepter is useful. Maybe that's how we get out. So maybe it's something that killed us. Or maybe, wait, are we looking for a thing? What is the thing we're looking for?
The thing you're looking for, as far as it's been described to you, is a piece of a lich.
Okay. That does not look like fleshy bits.
Mm-mm.
Well, does it have an eye?
It does have two eyes. Both seem to be stone and affixed inside of it.
Like, there aren't any tiles in the mosaic that seem amiss. Everything is pretty pristine.
Yeah, everything is pretty pristine. I mean, it does, so like your examination of the story that's being told here is that, you know, Coyote likes to steal, you know, shiny round objects in particular. So Coyote tried to steal the sun after trying to steal the moon in this one.
Ed.
Yes.
You made a whole bunch of shiny stuff in that that gold pool, right? Maybe if we give it a shiny round thing, it'll be happy and do something. That will help.
Really good idea.
I don't think I have anything that's shiny and round.
And he will take out a piece of gold and just like flip it into the middle of the room and not walk towards it.
Okay. Nothing seems to happen. You almost see like its mouth curl up on one side for a second, but then it just kind of goes back to normal.
I think it wants more valuable things than just one piece of gold.
Does Seabolt still have that vial of the goldening liquid? Or did he give that to Aku?
Gosh, I don't remember. I think he dumped it onto the platform.
Well, he would have placed the vial because it's obviously useless if it gets spilled.
Okay, so yeah, he like left it there, I guess.
Did we pass that room on the way around or something?
Not that I was told. It was kind of in a little nook. It's not too far away, but you do whatever you want. All right, Declan drops some money. The coyote-headed man that looks like Ed is smiling a little more now. You notice its arms raise up a couple inches that are holding the scepter.
I will give it 70 gold.
It's smiling really big now, and you can see these like sharp canines, and it holds up the scepter a little higher.
What is even happening right
now? Does it look like it's giving us the scepter? Is that what's happening?
I mean, it almost looks like a trade, like if somebody's like, you know, here you go.
I'll add the difference to 100. 100 golden metal.
How much was the Gem of Brightness worth after being consumed?
Let me see.
Was it 50 gold pieces?
That's a really good question that I don't have the answer to off the top of my head. So, let me...
So even with 100 gold, this thing hasn't let go of the scepter yet?
No, it's holding it. It's holding it out to you all.
It's like 120 gold at this point.
So he's offering it to us.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, nobody else is going to do it. I'll walk forward and take it.
Okay. You try to pick it up. It doesn't seem to budge. It's almost like it's stuck there in space.
I let it go, and I get frustrated and walk away. Looks like he's trying to give it to us, but not.
It looks over at Ed with the smiling face.
Oh, I guess I'll walk up and try to take it.
Okay. You try to take it. Nako Ray, will you come talk to me in the other talk room really quick?
It's the one
that says talk time. It's under the not D&D. Hi. So you have been turned to stone normally, but you're wearing the bracelet of petrification, which prevents you from being turned to stone. Okay. So I am going to need you to do that thing in movies where you know how, like, when something looks like you, you have to be like, that's not me, I'm me. Oh yeah, say something that only I would know. Okay, so this thing is going to look like you and it's going to have all of your memories. Okay. And it is going to both of you have, or so you have had a vision, like your actual character has had a vision, that this character has hidden the eye, and it has hidden it in, let's see here, I'm trying to remember where it was. Well, I don't want to go back down. Yeah, so it's hidden it through the exit of the dungeon in like a special hole. Okay, so it's going to try to not lead the characters there. It wants to lead the characters back into the dungeon where it's actually hidden it. Okay.
Wait, so it actually hid it at the exit.
Mm-hmm.
What is trying to trick us that it's
inside. Yeah, to go back deeper into the dungeon and get killed. And you're, like, normally you would have been frozen in stone, but you happen to be in a special circumstance where you can't be turned to stone. Does that make sense? So okay. You are going to have to argue with yourself. Are you comfortable with that?
Yeah.
You think so? Okay.
I think I get it, but, okay.
So there's two of you here, and the clothes that it was wearing look exactly like yours now. And, you know, it's kind of like there was at least some sort of like flash of light that prevented anybody from seeing now who's who. So that's what we're going to come back to. Okay.
Got it.
Okay. It's a weird one. Normally it would just be, you would just be playing the evil version of you and the real you would be stuck in stone. So here we go back to the other room. Okay. So there is a bright,
just before you jump into it, we didn't know how long you were going to be gone. So a few people stepped away for a second. So,
oh, okay. Well then, we'll continue in a second.
Yeah. After like the first 2 or 3 minutes, they were just like, hey, I'm going to step away and use the restroom.
Oh, okay. I should have. I didn't know how long I would take with that either, because this is.
No, it's all good. They'll be right back. I don't think anybody's taking like an extended break. It was like, I'm just gonna grab a glass of water. I'm gonna use the restroom, kind of thing.
Gotcha.
I told them I would hang out and let you know.
And I'm back.
Okay.
I'm back.
Just Janessa.
I also will be right back. I just remembered something.
Uh-oh. Okay. Well, we'll have to wait a second because we can't start until Nakoray is back, but that's okay.
That's fine. I mean, you can always set the scene, but mm-hmm. We might as well wait for everybody. Not a big deal.
Right.
I'm back.
Cool. So we're just waiting on
Eddie. Yeah. So essentially, there is a bright flash of light. That just like filled the room, and when you when you get your vision back, hold on 1 second here, there are two identical Ed standing next to each other.
I love that their names combined in the middle say emo.
That's funny.
So they're standing next to each other, and they both look sort of confused and bewildered.
I am confused and bewildered at what just happens.
Does one of them say that, or do they both say that at the same time?
Both of them at the same time.
Oh, are you feeling okay?
No. Never this better.
Weird and confusing. Is there like money still in the middle of the room?
Oh, there was. Oh, yeah, the money's still there. Yeah.
Hmm. Laura's going to raise her hand. And she has like a fist with her index and middle finger lifted, like a pointing at Ed.
Okay.
One of the Eds, I guess.
Okay.
Okay.
Then he's gonna take out a pebble in her sling and be like, I'm not, this probably won't even hit you, but I feel like, I don't know, like if we pinch one of you, do both of you feel it? I'm gonna try and shoot him.
You're going to try to shoot one of the ends.
Yes.
Both of you do not feel it. It just hurts. One of you.
Which one are you shooting? The one on the left or the one on the right?
The one on the left, I guess. I probably won't even hit. Oh, yeah.
You hit me in the head.
I'm sorry. Did it hurt?
Yes! Why?
Did it go through you? Is other Ed hurt?
No. I'm fine.
I'm going to move forward. Are both holding the scepter now, or is only one of them still holding the scepter?
So only one of them is holding the scepter. It is, I guess, the one on the left.
Oh, mark them as blue.
Okay.
The scepter holder.
I can do that.
Is one of them where? So Ed was wearing the gloves of the thing.
They're both wearing identical clothing.
Can I start gathering up the gold in the middle of the room and putting it back in my pouch and just try to keep an eye on them?
Of course.
Let them react.
I mean, they both seem to like gold.
Does the statue?
I do like gold.
Yeah, this wasn't your gold, right?
No.
Maeve has been sort of quietly staring at them. You know, she's got like her hand up to her chin, she's clearly thinking, and she just turns to Declan, tugs on his sleeve, and is like, can I just shoot them both?
Well, we don't know he's dangerous. This might just be some illusory effect. I mean,
he was dangerous before.
Like, yeah, you're right, fuck it,
this
shoot
is
him.
Getting out of hand.
No, don't,
now there are
don't.
Two of them.
No. Just give him a little tap.
Oh,
so, I don't want your love.
What was, like, one of Ed's simple cantrips that we would have seen? Does he have thaumaturgy? Right? He casts that one a lot.
I do have thaumaturgy.
He does like to hear himself talk.
I'm gonna ask
And he wants everyone else to hear it, too.
I'm gonna ask the one without the orb if he can like make the lights flicker or something. I don't remember if that looks dirty does that. I think it does.
Yeah, it does. I will use thaumaturgy and make the lights flicker. Or go
so
out.
So I can cast mad. The other one do it now.
The other one cast thaumaturgy.
It's like they're both real. I want to go poke him, but I feel like I'm going to die if I do that.
You won't die horribly.
You also told me to open the hatch, and look how that worked out.
So, the one on the left and the one, well, they both unanimously say, we've had a vision of the coyote god. The one on the left says that the gem that what you're seeking is inside the dungeon back the way we came. The other one on the right says that the it's further up going past where we've already come from.
Okay.
Did they both talk about the coyote?
Yeah.
That's okay. And what does Asmodeus want us to do?
The one on the right says Asmodeus wants you to sacrifice everyone.
But what does the one on the left say?
The one just says you should sacrifice people that you care about.
I'm moving back into the left, and I'm like, kill the one on the left! Kill
the one on the left! Laura is going to unleash... Oh, that didn't work. Laura's going to unleash a witch bolt on the one on the left.
Okay, make an attack roll, and then we're going to go into initiative.
That was a, I consider that... Oh, God, it didn't work.
Well, that's not the right roll anyway.
Well, it's her intelligence attack, but it's not working for some reason.
Got it.
But shouldn't you also have, like, a proficiency bonus?
That's true.
Not that it matters because you rolled a 1, but, you know.
Are we doing initiative, or did my audio die?
Yeah, we're doing initiative.
Okay. Cool beans. Oh, hey! It's Ed! Except he's blue.
Dubba-dee-dubba-dee.
Oh, that was the wrong... that was the wrong token.
Would have been funny if we had, like, actually attacked Ed.
I kind of wish I had made Maeve or you do that, Claire, because I think you would have drug it out so much more into, like, a weird way.
I don't know. I kind of figured that it wouldn't take too long to figure out.
Yeah, no, you did great. I'm just saying, I know Claire would have actually had extra fun with it, too.
A labyrinth puzzle. Anybody?
Would you say?
It's the puzzle from the labyrinth.
Yeah, the movie.
Yeah.
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 Yes.
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 Indeed.
Yes.
Indubitably.
Yes.
Affirmative.
I guess it's because I don't think it's going to have any effect on this. There was another, like, wrinkle in this and how this was supposed to work, and that's that the person that it was kind of keyed to gets turned to stone when they touch the scepter, but Ed is immune to being turned to stone, and I only remembered that during the last second. So I had to come up with a whole new scenario. So, okay. Laura, it's your turn.
Oh, goody. I have to fix my thing. Give me a second.
No.
You get nothing. Good day.
You lose.
Okay, whatever. It's, I think it doesn't give a crap about whether it's broken or not, so... She's going to... So she shoots a blast of, like, this blue lightning, and it hits the wall for some reason. And then she lowers her hand, and then she lifts it again, and then she goes, kapow. That didn't use the attack roll. Darn it.
What happened? Because I see an attack... Well, no, I see a damage roll here.
There we go.
Okay. A witch bolt hits.
She raises a witch bolt.
Okay. Oh man, I wish I had done this so differently. Okay, Ben, it's your turn.
Yeah, alright. That's a funky looking son of a gun. I guess I'm gonna have to hit him over the head.
Okay. You run over. Your attacks. Your third attack hits. I guess you're still peanut butter.
That's a given. Plus 8 means nothing, right?
And then it's Menny's turn. He just kind of is like, oh, you're hurting me real bad. Menny, go ahead.
I don't really have any spells left that I want to use, so I guess I'll just go up and shillelagh him in the face.
Okay. So you run up, you punch him in the dome.
Ooh.
Oh. Actually, well, good. Okay. And, wow, that did hit real good.
Yeah.
Okay. And he's just surrounded on all sides. He's freaking out. Maeve, it's your turn.
Oh, he's freaking out now, huh? Well, what if I walk up here and then I cast Vampiric Touch?
Oh, no.
And I attempt to drain the fucking life out of him.
Well, that hits.
Jesus. Wow.
Oh, everybody's just beating up on this freaking guy.
Hey, I was missing one HP. I needed it back.
That's so much damage.
Okay.
Well, that was one off of max, so.
Yeah, I know.
Very good roll.
Declan, I don't know if my guy is going to get to go, so go ahead.
Okay. So, I will, I guess, just shoot at him. Got my longbow out. There's not really anywhere to hide, so.
Okay. You fire and. That was some singles. Let's see here. Hot singles in your area. Seabolt, it's your turn.
Okay, Seabolt's gonna move behind. He's gonna move behind Minnie. And he's going to be all like, hey, halberd.
Okay, throw your halberd over Minnie's head and stab it in the chest. It howls out in terror, and unfortunately, it dies. I'm so sorry, everybody. He drops the scepter onto the ground.
Think it's safe to touch it now? Anybody?
Yes. Laura's witch bolt ends, and she turns her hand toward Ed. And she says, "How do we know it really is you? Maybe the other one just got unlucky."
I'm just gonna play on my violin the song of my people.
Performance check. Performance check.
It's not my best performance.
Plus 10, holy crap.
Wow. I imagine it's like what's it called? Like a thing on a electric guitar, like it goes like.
Sure.
I have absolutely no idea what you're talking about.
A riff.
A riff.
Okay.
A sick lick.
Oh God.
Okay, that satisfies Laura.
You tried.
Manny's gonna not touch the thing that's on the floor. She's just gonna look at it.
It seems valuable.
We're gonna take it.
You know, Maeve's gonna pick it up. She's like, looks safe.
All right, you take it. It seems to have lost its sticky powers to only be picked up by Ed. The scepter is worth 200 gold pieces.
Holy balls.
Okay. Well, good job solving my doppelganger riddle. Stupid doppelganger riddle.
I'm sorry, I wasn't a better doppelganger.
That one's awesome.
Yeah.
I really like that.
Doppelgangers are great.
Yeah, so
please sacrifice the ones you love.
So normally it tries to lead you somewhere more dangerous, you know. And there wasn't that whole aspect of there being something else you need to find. So it was just kind of, you know, I had to think on the fly there. Declan wanders off sullenly.
Okay, so we're supposed to go back the way we came? Is that what you said, Ed?
No, we gotta go towards the exit.
Oh, okay.
That's where the fox god has hidden the treasure that we seek.
Cool.
Yeah, but where's the exit?
Further up.
Oh, okay. So I guess that makes sense.
Okay, so you're heading to the hallway?
Where'd Declan go? Declan! Oh, he's this way. I'm not going through.
Hey, Ed. I'm sorry I almost killed you.
I didn't hit you in the head. I hit the other one in the head. Never mind.
Yeah.
I'm glad I picked him.
Alright, so everybody is in this hallway. Who's going first? I assume this is your marching order?
During the previous thing?
Yeah. Yeah, but then I healed 8. So...
What, oh. Can you say that again?
Marching order.
So obviously, Manny is very, like, I don't want to go first. So Laura's going to go ahead of Manny.
Mm. Where's Ben?
He's up here.
Oh, okay. I can't be.
Is Laura gonna go before or after Deglin, though?
You can go in the open spot, that's fine.
Yeah, it's totally gonna be there, the marching order.
Let's go.
Okay, so. Move along home, Ben. You're going up here. You see you don't see a lot because you don't have great vision. So you see a lever right here, and you see a portcullis right here. Or maybe you do. If you move up far enough, you would.
All right. Just a lonely lever.
Just a lonely lever. In fact, let me read some flavor text for us.
This lever has no...
Before you is a foyer 10 feet wide and 20 feet long. A narrow hall connects with this area on the south side, and on the north end, a 5-foot staircase leads up. So that's through the portcullis. The wheel is set horizontally halfway into the wall. The southwest corner appears to be a crank. Above the wheel, a bronze lever is set in the wall, angled downwards. So the portcullis is raised currently, I should mention, as well.
Can you ping where the portcullis is? Perhaps?
Yeah, of course. It is right here. Oh, right here.
Oh, that's so close.
Raised as in closed or open?
Open.
I
it
see.
Is currently open.
Hmm. And yet there's a lever here.
Yes. Discuss amongst yourselves. I'm going to grab a beer.
Shall I pull it?
That's right.
Should I pull the lever?
I mean,
sorry, pull the lever. Really, wrong.
Wrong lever.
Why do we even have that lever?
Doesn't seem like we have any other options to open it. So.
Oh, you know, might as well. See what happens.
I could send Beautiful Assistant ahead. Well, oh, no, never mind. Beautiful Assistant does not want to go ahead. So that's a...
Okay, hold on one second. I think there was a misunderstanding. You can hear me, right? I didn't mute myself.
Yeah, you're good.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's see here. The portcullis is currently open, so you can go up the stairs.
Oh. So we don't want to pull the lever, probably.
Well, it's up to you. I just wanted to make sure that was absolutely clear.
Is there something at the top of the stairs that will crush us?
Hmm.
Eat our souls.
That is also up to you and your imagination.
Well, those are small stairs.
A narrow staircase winds up before you.
Oh, you know what? I'm just gonna... Laura's going to run ahead. Why is it that Laura has a frowny face, by the way, next to her?
I don't know. I didn't put that there.
Wasn't that your sleepy coma face?
Yeah, I think that was your coma sleepy face. And then on Seabolt is the having great times icon.
Oh, yeah.
My frolicking icon.
Yes.
There we go. She goes up for the stairs.
Celebrate good times with demons.
Let me
know if someone stops you, or sorry, stops you.
Sure, I will.
Or
I'm paying attention.
Should I pull the lever?
I
not now that she's gone.
You know, I'm just gonna go over here before you pull that lever.
I'm gonna pull the lever.
Okay, so you're opening the lever or turning the lever. All right, you start cranking the lever. Can I have Declan make a dexterity saving throw?
Oh, no.
Okay. Declan, you're able to move out of the way as the floor begins to shift and it kind of like starts sliding away from the wall. Ben, make a dexterity or an acrobatics or a dexterity save or acrobatics check, I should say.
Three.
Okay, so you're actually okay. You notice that you're standing on a ledge. The floor is about half...
wings.
Yeah, and you have wings too. And the floor is about halfway exposed. So... you can see down below... Well, you can't see very well, but you think you see a bone... Ed, you look down and you can see lots of bones.
Oh boy, it's fun down there. You should go down there. There's like one skeleton. That's it. He might have been, you know, lonely. You should go visit.
Oh, I'm going to toss one of the torches down there so I can take a gander at what really is down there.
All right. There seem to be numerous skeletons lining the bottom of this pit.
That's it? Just skeletons, or...?
Yeah, that seems to be it. Just a lot of skeletons down there.
Why do all adventurers come down here naked?
You know, I don't know. That's a really good question. I mean, there could be, like, kobolds that run through occasionally and scoop up most of their treasure.
I hope so.
Yeah. That's
I like to imagine one of the kobold architects was like, no one would ever pull this lever. That's stupid. There's no reason to.
Wait a minute.
They're making one of their removal runs and just like, shut up, Jerry. Don't say a goddamn word.
With the way the lever is cranked right now, it looks as though it is only the floor is only halfway open and exposed. And Laura, did you go to the top of the stairs?
Yes, she did.
There is a wall. What do you do?
Hey, Benjamin, you should pull that lever.
I'm gonna pull a lever.
Okay, you crank the lever the rest of the way. The floor slides all the way open, revealing the stupid adventurers that fell in this hole. The wall that Laura is standing in front of opens up and reveals more stairs going upwards, but that's not part of this map.
Yeah.
Onward.
You did it.
You let go of the lever, and the lever starts to spin backwards, and the door starts to the wall starts to close.
Oh no!
Push back down.
All right, you hold it back down. It begins to. It stays open as you're holding it.
What exactly are you doing, Ben?
Holding the lever.
Hold the lever, Kronk.
We'll miss you, Birdman.
Can we, like, wedge it with something? I have a tea set. That seems not useful.
A tea set.
We could use one of the corpses, or all the corpses.
There's a lot of bones.
That probably would work, to be honest. Are we sure they're actually dead?
I'm pretty sure they're bones. They're pretty bones.
There's nothing else in the pit with them.
I have an idea, but we need to close the lever first so I can get back across.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Okay.
Go over with Ben.
Uh-huh.
Once it's closed, I'm going to go into my dungeoneering kit.
Okay.
And I'm going to take out like 3 or 4 pitons.
Okay.
And hammer them into the wall.
All right.
I'm going to take my rope, tie it around the lever, and then kind of show Ben how to weave it in and out of the pitons and tell him to tie the rope when he's done, you know, after the lever's been cranked, weave it through the pitons, tie a knot in the end.
All right. So you're leaving it, but you're not cranking it? God.
I'm
phrasing.
Crank it in front of everybody.
No, so you're just going to let Ben crank it.
Yeah, the one who can fly above.
Yeah, okay.
I'm going to let him do that.
Okay. So Ben starts cranking it, and you know, I guess it, you like loop the lever stuck in place, and you're looking next to you, and the portcullis slams shut once the lever can't spin backwards anymore. Like, it feels that it's somehow feeling the tension of this rope, and it causes the portcullis to slam shut right next to Declan.
That's some fancy technology.
But it is held in place, and the wall is still open. About or where?
Can I hand my crowbar to Seabolt, see if he can break the bars?
Yeah, Seabolt would need to make a strength check or a strength athletics check with advantage. Uh-oh.
You know what? I take the crowbar and be like, give me that.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, wow. The bar just activates beast mode, and he like moves the portcullis up, like hammer, like grabs like one of Declan's pitons, like nails the portcullis open, and just like without breaking a sweat, just like, and everything seems to be open now.
And this is why you bring a bard that somehow is very strong, became a cleric. Reasons.
This door keeps opening and closing and opening and closing, and what's happening down there?
You sound really far away. Is that an effect, or is that just your mic?
That's me being far from my mic.
That's
she's upstairs, and not everybody can.
Yeah,
everybody's upstairs.
That was very effective.
Yeah, I'm gonna make sure everybody gets through, and then I guess we'll continue up the stairs.
All right. You move up the stairs, and let me just take a look at that map and also get us up there. Hold on one sec. I'm gonna get everything staged really quick to where you come out. Oh, that was just one token. I didn't grab you all. One moment. Hopefully I got you all that time.
And then he moves us, our thingy, into the... What is going on over there?
Nothing. All right, hold on. Let me just check that delightful text.
And then you have to move our bookmark and stuff.
I will. I'm just looking at a couple things really quick, making sure we don't miss any important things.
Like treasure?
Treasure?
Sure.
You know what else starts with a T? Traps. And terror.
All right.
Torment. Torture?
I couldn't fit all of you in that stairway, but there seems to be like a let's see here, hold on.
Is there a wall?
Yeah, there is a wall here. I need to do a read for a second because I thought this was pretty straightforward, but there's something I'm missing here. So just hold on one sec.
No.
The puzzle gets bored.
I mean, it is 9:50. Is that a good place to take like an official break?
Yeah, you guys can take your official break. And I'll be here, sadly and alone.
Time for more scotch.
Yeah, I mean, if you need time when we get back, just take your time then.
Okay. Yeah. Go get your things.
I'm back.
Okay. I think we're good.
Oh, wait. You can probably hear me, like, chewing gum now.
Okay, everybody, is anybody still gone, I should ask?
I don't think so.
I mean, I guess it's hard for them to answer if they are.
Yeah.
I am here, Emmy's here, Claire is here. What about the other threes? Yes if you're here.
Yes.
All right.
Okay.
The boys are still AFK.
I'm still here. What?
Oh, nice. All right.
Who thinks they have the highest passive perception?
Not me.
The stoke.
I mean, it's possible it's me, but I don't know.
Okay, just give me some numbers here.
Pretty sure that's not me.
Oh yeah, it's got a very good chance of being Ben.
Staples of 14. Wow.
I think Maves is... I don't remember what Maves is. It might be 12.
Okay. So 14 is maybe our highest then?
Yeah, you can probably check Ben's sheet.
I will.
He'll be the only one that's higher than 14. I'm also at 14.
Man, Seabolt's got a higher passive perception than the scope.
I'll just wait for everybody to get their alcohol.
Yeah, I mean, to be fair, it's only been, it just hit 5 minutes, so.
Yeah. No, I'm not impatient. You're impatient.
No, what? I should have interrupted you. That would have been a better way to protest that.
This was a really interesting run of this dungeon.
Is it because Laura put some stuff in her mouth?
I mean, I guess we could.
That sounds sexual.
We could say that, but I would say, I mean, part of it's because you guys didn't really get a lot of the loot.
We didn't.
I mean, you got about half of it.
Were there, like, fancy magic items that we missed? Because that'll make me sad.
I mean, I'll never tell.
You can tell us later so we can, or I guess just me, so I can be sad forever. Never, never dreaming of.
Oh.
I mean, just think of all the rooms that you were like, oh, that looks scary. Nope.
I mean, it has to do with character motivation, though, right?
Like, yeah, you did a great job.
None of the rooms here have anything to do with, like, let's find out what happened here, or like, let's explore.
Oh yeah, no, I mean,
poisonous gas.
Poison.
You're in
yeah,
an unknown land, and there's a lich that needs to be stopped, and there is some kind of a cult or faction chasing you. None of that warrants itself to like, hey, take your time, take a look around. Like,
you're there was like a Matt Colville video how he's talking about metagaming and how like. I mean, if the characters are like diehard adventurers and treasure seekers, like of course they're gonna go, you know, every inch of a dungeon looking for stuff. But some characters aren't built that way. So you know, if you have a party of people that have made their characters into treasure finders, then it makes sense for them to do that. But sometimes it's just not how it goes. So
yeah, the mentality I'm trying to keep is like, if I'm looking for my keys, I don't think it's a good time to like go look through my old, you know, high school yearbook. Like, there are better places to look for that. There are things that need to be done.
Right.
If it was like, this air in here is giving you health and you've realized you have nothing better to do for the next 3 months, what do you do? All right, fuck it.
Yeah, now you got the mummy fever.
Indeed.
The mummy tummy.
Shows you all the good it does to explore. Just get it debilitated.
Go to Chult, they said. It'll be fun, they said.
Yeah, and this is an adventurers league where you can just be like, help, I need a cleric. Here's my money. I've got, give me a greater restoration, please.
Yeah, I don't even think that would work, right? I think mummy rot's remove curse.
Oh, yeah, it is. But still, you can buy remove curse as well.
Well, lucky you, remove curse is cheaper than greater restoration.
Yeah, everything's cheaper at the end of a blade.
What is it level a level 3 spell?
Yeah, it's a third level spell.
Greater restoration includes curses in the thing that it deals.
Greater resto.
I mean, there's also a chance that many can prepare it. I don't even know.
No, I don't have that.
No, remove curse, I don't think is something the druids get.
Oh, no,
warlocks get it.
It's yeah. Like, yep. But Maeve has to know it.
And probably Bard. I don't know.
Maeve would have to actually take that spell.
And a paladin would get it like at level fucking 12 or whatever. However long it takes to get decent spell slots.
Yeah, I have lesser, but not greater.
Level 7?
Okay. Looks like we're still just waiting on Rob, but he can't hear us, so... Mm-mm-mm. Well, what's the marching order? Who would be in front here?
Laura's in front.
Yeah, I mean, we can't really see shit, so I'm assuming it's just the same as it was.
Some combination of Laura, Maeve, and Seabolt up front, I guess?
Sure.
Actually, I'm thinking Seabolt might be in the back.
Oh, okay. Seabolt's on their guard duty then.
You two and Ben.
Yep.
Sure.
Okay. I guess we can have Laura breach the door if she wants to. It's openable. You can see the latch. All right. Let me move that light for you. Okay. You see an altar before you, but to your left and your right, you see these giant coyotes that are salivating at you, and they attack.
Freak. As she closes the door.
Well, I want to see if they can beat your initiative since you walked out, so yes.
Wrong house.
Oh, shit, those are big.
Those
have been eating their vegetables.
Okay, let's see.
Oh, those are big boys. Is this a double door? I can't see it.
No, it's hard because I can't squeeze y'all in there, so.
Double door dies.
All right, everybody roll initiative. Yes.
Dang.
Sorry, trying to open my character sheet since we switched maps, but being piled on top of everybody was hard to click on for a second.
Hey friends, you don't mind that I have no spells, right?
I do not have many of them, so you know, you're not alone.
Actually, I'm gonna reduce this to 3, because y'all have been so good. I think that's doable. Okay.
Probably the last one, the one that got 18 in the initiative.
I just deleted one and didn't even check. Whoopsie.
Oh, that also works.
So it looks like you're all going to go first anyway. So you can make your decision as to what you're going to do. Declan, you hear the growling before you see it. You're kind of squished in the back there. You're not... doing too good health-wise. What do you do?
I probably crouch down and try to steady my breathing and pull out my bow and wait.
Okay. Laura, you notice that you're surrounded by 3 giant coyotes. Not hyenas. Definitely coyotes.
I'm still looking at my spells, honestly.
Okay.
Okay, so when
when one of them comes at her, she's going to do some attacking with her. She's going to take that fancy attack action thing with her, the weapon and the other weapon.
Oh, shoot. One more. But if I'm going to take away a hyena, I'm going to do one more thing. Everybody take your six poison gas. Last poison gas die. Six damage.
I thought we were not taking poison gas anymore because of the caudle. Was that not a thing?
No, but that is a good point. Laura, you're immune to that particular poison gas now from your experience being comed. So.
Fancy.
Yeah. Although that's extra bad for Declan.
Oh, no.
So, okay.
I keep forgetting you can't be healed.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
So the difficulty has now been, okay, Laura, you're out in the open. There's hyenas.
She's gonna step
I'd rather have the extra hyena.
And she says, there are three
coyotes.
Big monsters. Don't come in. And she's ready to strike at the one who attacks her first.
Okay, so you're
the extra attack off and the bonus action?
No, it would just be one, I believe, from what I've seen. So you could just charge it.
Okay. This is Laura's last stand. So she's going to bring her blade through this coyote.
Okay.
And she's also going to bring the lightning through. She's going to bring the thunder. And then she's going to bring the lightning.
Oh, wow. So both, all of those hit, especially that juicy good crit. This coyote is just, it's pretty wrecked already. Let's see. 15.
She says, I won't let you take me down.
So what is that, 23? No, 20. 33? 28. 28. Okay. It is heavily bloodied already. So just from your whirlwind of strikes, you say your one-liner and it is just bleeding from multiple stab wounds. Ben, it's your turn.
Where are we going?
All right, you are going to lose most of your movement getting out, but I'm sure you could make it to like right there.
That's fine. 50 should be enough to get through there.
Oh, yeah, you could probably move further than that, actually. But, you know, you're double moving through your friends, so I didn't know what to do with you.
Let's go.
Oh, I think I forgot to roll for Cybolt.
By the way, as you left the dungeon, your quarterstaff turned back to a regular old angry stick.
That disappoints me. Am I still peanut butter?
Yeah, I would say that the peanut butter still remains for now. So that's 20 damage. You destroy the hyena with the last strike. So all three were required to do that, or the coyote.
Is that 30?
Sorry, did you need me to reorganize Seabolt in there? Is that what you were about to say?
Yeah, Seabolt was, I forgot to roll for him.
Okay, just a sec. Okay, and what? Anything else, Ben? I guess that's kind of it for you, no, huh?
Just the 30 damage and that's it.
Okay.
Yeah, that's all.
Yeah, that's a good one. Maeve, it's your turn.
I'm going to step on out and I'm going to shoot this bad boy. This totally not a hyena. But Maeve doesn't know what a hyena is, so I don't think she knows what a coyote is either. Achoo!
Alright, you fire your longbow. It does hit the giant coyote, and that is gonna do 6 damage. Anything else?
Nope.
Okay. It is time for a big old doggy. It's gonna run up. Both of you two did quite a lot of damage. I'm gonna have it attack Laura Lightwind because she was first out the door. Does a 17 hit you?
It does not.
Okay.
It bites into her armor.
the plate armor.
Yeah.
And its teeth break a little bit on the metal.
Yeah, it leaves a little bit of a dent, but not by much. No, you could buff that right out. Seabolt, it's Seabolt's turn.
All right. Oh, that's weird how it did partial damage. Okay, so one of these guys just died. He is going to be like... Oh, yes, okay. He is going to let out a rallying cry as a bonus action. He's not really the squire anymore, but whatever. So, who is visible? Okay, so Benjamin, Laura, and Maeve are going to get heals, the 4 points of heals.
Okay.
And also, Seabolt is going to... That rallying cry is also a roar. And he's trying to show that that we are bigger than the hyenas.
Okay.
To scare off this one.
Okay. Does it have to make a wisdom save, or is that just extra thing?
Can I make an intimidation check?
Sure.
Roar.
Okay. It seems little...
Seabolt doesn't have the rallying cry, so you guys don't restore health.
What? Did you change him up? Okay.
No, he does have the rallying cry, but he doesn't have it. He already used it.
Okay. So reverse the damage. Okay, does he roar? And anything else that you want to do instead, or...?
I don't know if the intimidationings is a bonus or is an action.
It's a free action. Usually what I do is if it fails by a lot, you know, on like a opposed wisdom check or, then I'll like maybe give it disadvantage, but it didn't fail by that much. So.
Wow.
Okay. And that did fail to hit. So that didn't work out for you.
It's just a warning attack.
Yeah. It's Manny's turn.
Okay. I think I can just barely get out.
Okay. But do you have anything you can do?
Oh, yeah. I'm going to cast Healing Spirit.
Okay.
Just kidding. No, I'm not, because I keep clicking at it in the wrong spot forever. Where are you? That actually should be level 4. So I don't know how to do that from this front page.
It should give you the option. Oh yeah.
I'm not 100% sure Healing Spirit is affected by higher level.
It would say there, but I don't know.
Okay.
I think it is. Yeah, when you cast a spell using spell third slot or higher, blah 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 blah.
Okay, cool.
So hang on, let me check my settings. See if there's
You probably had to manually add that there, right? Since Xanathar's isn't in there.
Yeah. Probably.
Which probably under your spell description, under your spell tab, there's normally for a spell there's at higher levels XYZ.
Yeah, it's just for damage though. So I mean, I have it in there.
Yeah.
But it didn't ask me for higher level. Which normally it does. So whatever, I guess I'll just roll it manually.
Yeah, I think unless it's in the compendium, I'm 99% sure it won't prompt you. Because it treats it as a custom spell.
So it's just 2d6. So 6 plus 5. 11. I'm going to put in... whoever Declan can't heal. I guess right between Laura and Ben.
I mean, yeah, it could just kind of be in the middle of everybody for the most part. So many boys.
So everybody heals 11. Woo.
Yeah, it was a good roll.
All right, Well, I should have had four hyenas. I always should have more enemies, is the lesson.
Yep.
Okay.
So don't be nice to your players.
I mean, I'm also going to turn into a bear. If I can. Like, hover over people and not squish them as a bear.
Yeah, if you still got transformations, you're kind of just... You're kind of blocking the exit. Actually.
Yeah. Whatever, I'm going to do it anyway.
Okay. Ed, you're way down there. I'm sorry for that. I don't know why I had you in last, but I'll at least put you here.
It's all right. I'm just going to move up, and then I'm just going to toll the dead.
Okay. You toll the hyena that's been hit, I assume, because that's kind of your MO. Yep. So you're like, aha, I see. They're fighting that one. And... it's going to make a wisdom save. It fails. So it takes the full, the both of those?
Yep.
Okay.
I keep forgetting this. Toll the Dead also increase damage when they're hurt.
I think Toll the Dead is increased damage. Right, yeah. The dice gets higher if the creature has been injured.
It turns into a d12. So that should be... D12s, not D8s.
Okay. I will figure that one out. It's less 3D12. Damage.
3D12.
It can't be 3D12.
Didn't you higher cast?
Yeah, so it was one extra D8, I believe. But his spell...
Right, the first one probably had...
Okay.
Three?
It is the other beastie's turn, though, and it is...
Does it get scared away because there's a swarm of tiny things murdering its friends?
It's not scared away. I wish that I had an extra hyena. It is going to move through Seabolt's space, but it's shifting around Seabolt because it doesn't want to attack Seabolt, and it's going to attack Ed.
Want to move Seabolt just to see? Okay, never mind.
And it bites Ed for 11 damage.
Ed hurt.
And it is Declan's turn.
All right. The whole come to us thing didn't really work out, so let me move Seabolt just so I can see my vision. And I can, yeah, okay. So I can see both of them from here. I'm going to attack the one that just attacked Ed.
Okay.
Has it been injured yet, just out of curiosity?
It has not.
Okay. Did I have advantage since it didn't know I was there? Like, was I hidden?
Make your stealth check and I'll just oppose it.
Sure.
Oh, Manny is yes. Not in the space that she chose her and okay. So that's an open space.
So that's 8 on the attack plus 2 for sneak. Damage.
Okay, so 30 damage. Everybody does 30. So, you know, lesson learned. I'm just not going to take it easy on you all ever again. Laura.
Should have done both the 6 and the extra.
What?
Oh, no, that's right. I got the 7 and the 1 from the weapon attack, and then double sneak attack damage.
Yeah.
So 30.
Laura, go ahead.
All right. Laura is going to bring this, which blade is she? Oh, gosh. Okay, she's going to fold down the Master's Honor fan thing and stab in the face. And I don't know it, but it, yeah, I don't think that kills that. So she's going to bring the lightning once again.
That one does miss.
And that one misses. And then she's going to try to bring the thunder. Oh gosh, that also misses, I think.
No, that third one does hit. So how did you get the third one? Oh, because you have 3 attacks now, because you have 2 primary attacks, right?
Yeah, 2 weapon fighting and extra attack.
All right, let me get that in here.
That one's easy because it's 31.
It is. And that kills it. It is Ben's turn. Your kill stealing friend just took away all the fun.
I guess we gotta go to the sulfur.
Alright, you move through. The healing spirit feels warm and tingly.
Whoops.
You start.
Ignore just, the short sword.
You start ripping into it like crazy. Just destroying it. It wouldn't matter. If I had four, to be dead. It's all of my dreams. All of my dreams are nothing. They're useless.
And then another comes out from behind.
No, it's over. Game over, everybody.
It's over. You killed it.
Stop. You know, you're in a dungeon that's...
Everybody go home.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, there were four, but then Seabolt scared one of them off.
The difficulty of the dungeon was based on you all being surrounded by poison gas and wanting to explore and get treasure, but getting locked really poisoned the whole time. And since you ran through, you didn't have to worry about that. So, really, you're smarter than the average adventurers or something. Okay.
So are we gonna go on your adventure?
This was apparently a large temple of some sort, once a major building. All that remains are the back wall and enough of the roof to shelter the altar. All else seems closed off by fallen debris. Several pillars have fallen and they litter the floor. Sunlight filters through holes in the roof, 35 feet overhead, which is a maze of chips and cracks. The back wall is covered by a bas relief of a giant bat thing. It literally says giant bat thing. 9 feet tall with a wingspan of 20 feet. In front of this wall is an altar of stone carved to represent a mass of squirming rats, weasels, and worms. On the front of the altar is the head of a screaming bat. Jutting above the altar on either side are a pair of sharp-edged metal bat wings, 8 feet long. The floor in front of the altar is worn and smooth. Yeah, so there's a big altar here. Ed, you remember that this altar has to do something with Coyote's plan?
Ah, yes, his plan. What was his plan?
Well, all you know is it involved the altar.
We should probably move this altar, guys.
It does look like it can be tipped on its side.
Awesome. Like the side towards me?
Yeah.
And all the right. Wings,
I move.
Do the wings double as guillotine blades?
I hope so. Because they are metal.
Is that how we perform sacrifices?
So you open the altar slowly. Let's see. Can I have Seabolt make a dexterity save?
Oh.
So this is how he dies.
No. He died by getting shot with an arrow in the heart.
So the batwing slices through the air as it's being moved and kind of like reaches out towards him.
It cuts off the end of the arrow.
And it does 16 damage to him.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Where's the dog?
You are able to get it open.
Okay, I want to look at the health before he petted the dog out.
Okay.
He's pretty low. He's going to pet the dog out.
Okay. So you all open the tomb. And it appears to, or the altar, it appears to have a bounty of wealth underneath it. There are also two bodies underneath it that are cut in half. Beneath it is a treasure trove. There is 20,000 silver pieces Jesus. 50 silver chased goblets worth 5 gold pieces each, 20 gold-plated statuettes, 40 embossed silver chalices, 80 pieces of jewelry. There's a lot. That's just a lot.
Okay, we have to take the chalices. That's just too cool to not take.
Pretty good. Wait, so the stuff that was turned gold is no longer gold anymore, was that said?
Yes. And yeah. there is also a gleaming crystal eye with a pupil carved into it and an iris and all the other eyeball stuff.
Oh, I want that so much. I want to touch it.
All right, you touch it. It seems pretty harmless.
It speaks to me of wonder. It's beautiful. Is this what love is?
So, from the distance, you hear the beat of horse hooves.
Oh, shit.
Quick, hide the treasure.
Scoop it up. Scoop it up.
Move the altar back.
Disciple, get the heals from the pet the doggo.
Yes.
I don't know how many heals he gets.
I mean, basically, you can all cheat and just heal to full, except for Declan, who can't.
Yeah. He's probably gone at this point, but... Ed and Ben did not heal.
So, you hear hoofbeats in the distance. You see, a single, well, Maeve, you look back and you see a single rider, to the east side of this map, the true east, not the map east. And he is tall, wearing, dark armor that is covered in gashes. He doesn't seem to be injured. His armor just seems to be heavily battle-worn. There are a trail of horses running behind his horse that seem tethered to it. And he is coming to the temple.
So I'm just gonna be like, hey, some jerk face is here, string your bows. And I'm gonna have my bow at the ready.
Okay.
Time to go. We should go.
Go where?
Anywhere but here. There are people hunting these things. We gotta go.
I got all this stuff.
You can't just stand here and wait.
Can you turn into a horse? A war horse? Obviously.
Me? No, I can't turn into anything anymore. I'm just a bear. I can carry people as a bear.
Okay.
I got an hour? 2 hours? A level.
The horses are closing
like an
in.
An hour per level of druid, so I think you're good.
2 hours.
Can I legitimately use my one invisibility spell and get out?
Yeah, if you'd like to try that. So you're turning invisible? Where are you going to go?
I don't know.
Are they coming from this direction?
Yes, they are. Yeah. And they should be here in about 3 minutes. Or just the one person. It's one rider, followed by a trail of riderless horses.
Are they, like, wearing anything?
The horses, are they wearing anything?
Yes, I'm not the dude, but are the horses wearing anything?
The horses are wearing leather barding, but other than that, no.
Because, like, the other dudes that were hunting us had, like, kind of a uniform, didn't they?
Yeah, he seems, it's hard to tell from, he's pretty close now, but he's not wearing any... like traditional, like Zentarum or what was I gonna say?
You said he's basically just like head to toe in armor, right?
Yeah.
No cloaks, cowls, giant flying snakes.
No, he does have
that we can see, of course.
He does have like a very impressive long sword and shield on his back. He is.
Well, he could be anybody.
Laura is going to use
exactly
the time
he could be Laura
has.
He could be bringing us horses.
Laura's going to use the short amount of time that she has to use her Mold Earth spell
okay
to try to build walls with the rubble.
Okay. I need you to make a save here, because as you do this, like, you start to notice that the fragileness of this place is not liking things being moved around. Make a
rocks is usually Declan's job.
Make a dexterity save. Okay, you are able to avoid a slide of rocks, and it actually helps you. You're able to make like a small barrier. At least it, you know, increases the difficult terrain in front of the there. It should also provide cover. Up to 3/4 cover.
But it won't give a full...
Not full cover, no.
Block. Okay. That's fair.
So there are... Yeah, so the rider comes up and he gets off the horse. And he says, hello. Did you find it?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Look, I mean, I understand what the...
It's like a rumbly noise.
I understand what your destiny was. To find the hidden item. I thought... Well, I mean, where was it in there? I don't even remember where we put it.
Your voice sounds familiar.
He takes off his helm, and it is Thokan, although he looks like... heavily scarred. His eyes are sunken in and red, and he is, yeah, so he's got a couple like mean facial scars. He has kind of some like black war paint drawn under his eyes, and his, I don't, what color did he have hair at all on his head?
Not on the top half of his head, but he did have a pretty gnarly ass beard.
Yeah, so his beard is like shock white now. And he looks ancient.
So he's actually
How
alive?
Are you even alive?
I mean, he still looks like jacked as shit, but he looks just like...
Essentially, he looks like fucking Kratos now.
he's just like, look, I wasn't able to get word to you, but I heard from, you know... a mutual friend that you were coming down here. I know that you probably have a lot to carry. I brought you horses. Look, hand me the eye and I will lead you to Silvery Moon. It's a long journey from here.
Insight check.
All right.
Laura is going to raise her hand in the way she did before.
Okay.
When she was threatening Ed. And she says, you're dead.
No.
There's
a long story behind that.
400 years ago.
There's more to the story than you know. It's a long story and I can tell you on the way. Let me tell you about your insight checks. You guys can't... He seems to be the genuine article.
Does he smell normal?
He does smell normal.
Something only Thokan would know.
Well, let's see.
Only Thokan would know? That sort of limits things.
I like to spit in the mouths of my enemies. let's see. I'm married to Mimi. Although she hasn't talked to me in a long time, that's also part of the story.
Yeah.
I mean, that's pretty much it. Look, we're trying to save the world. Zhentarim, they're coming. The Red Wizards are coming. You know, you don't mess with those Thanes.
Can I take over for a second?
Yeah.
I thought the Saiyans were the good guys.
I'm just gonna like run up past everybody and like do like a slide across the barricade, and I don't know where he is, but I'm gonna basically get right up next to him. Is he on the map? I don't know where.
Yeah, I'll put him like right there. So.
Einar all along.
And I guess I'll like pull up. I'm gonna pull up next to him and like pull down my sleeve and show him like the rot that I have, and be like, that fucking thing you put in there. I'm not going anywhere until you fix this.
Well, really, we found it in there, and we just left it there.
Yeah, and then we had to come here and clean up your goddamn mistakes.
Okay. Yeah, I can help with that.
Okay. Maeve would like to interject. It did keep the gem safe until now.
It was buried after the gem.
Yeah, what's up with that? Was it like right out here? I could have gotten that. That's silly.
No more talking. Fix this.
Seems like, yeah, it was just under a rock.
Yeah, he reaches out and he you know, touches you and cures you. And he says,
just like throw my hood up and whisper prick and walk away.
Look, I'm sorry.
Nice.
But look, we need your help. We have to strategize. Come here. I got horses for all of you. Maeve asks how you know if he's the real Thoken. He says, I don't know what I can do to prove it to you.
You just hear like a light fart.
Yeah.
Maeve is I think she's unwilling to give up the eye at this point.
Look, I understand that you're a real hero, but you need to give me the eye because I am able to...
Well, now she's really suspicious because she's not a hero.
Well, I'm just assuming. Look, I can protect it better than most people. I'm not trying to sound, you know, like I'm full of myself, but...
You're pretty old. I'm gonna be honest. You look like someone who's gonna be visited by the Reaper real soon.
Look. I appreciate what you're trying to say.
Don't know why.
Can you?
Very polite.
He kind of walks closer to you. Can you make a wisdom saving throw?
Let's find out.
You are held, and he takes the eye from you.
I'm not okay with that, though. I will snarl at him.
What? And he, you snarl at him, you can bite him.
I'm not gonna bite him, I'm just gonna, like, hover over.
He stands back next to the horses and he says, "All right, mount up." And he gets on his horse and,
Wait, did he get the gem or did he
Laura's her? Gonna cast a spell.
What are you casting?
She's going to cast Witch Bolt.
Okay.
Yeah, you better roll at least a 25. He's probably got Shield of Faith up.
He gets on his horse and he says, "Look, I'm giving you a fair chance. I'm sorry." And he cuts the rope that the horses are attached to his horse and he rides off.
Yeah, no, I'm going to get on the horse and ride after him.
Okay.
Am I still, paralyzed?
Does he have it or not?
He does. Yeah, you're the hold person. Make another save, Maeve. Okay, you're out of it. He begins riding off. As you guys are riding through the... Are all the rest of you getting on horses?
Yeah, I'll drop and get on a horse.
Okay. As you're riding through across the... This is kind of like a flattened part of the jungle. Like, it looks like it's been heavily logged. So there's all these stumps. The ground is squishy and muddy. You're racing after Thokan, but he has this, like, you know, paladin warhorse, so it's imbued with magic. And he's going extremely fast. You see him pull a horn out of his saddlebag, and he blows it into the air. And after about 60 seconds from the sky, you see like the sun get blackened out by a shape, and it swoops down at Declan, who's in the lead. Let me get everybody here.
And I mean, like, to be clear, like, I'm yelling at him, like, slow down, you idiot, I'm following you. I'm not, like, I'm not shooting at him or anything. I got on the horse and chased him because it was like, you gotta get the fuck out of here.
How fast does a horse move?
Warhorse, I think, has 50 feet.
60.
Yeah, there you go.
In other words, half as fast as Thoken's horse.
Right.
What happens if I cast fly on a horse?
Then it's a flying horse.
The horse learns how to fly.
And your terrified horse flails about.
Standblade.
Oh, I don't know.
Aww, it's the old Laura token.
A terrified horse starts a petition to end animal abuse.
Can a monk dash twice? One with bonus action and one with normal dash?
Yeah, you can.
You have to spend a key point, right?
Yeah, I could probably catch up to the horse.
Bear in mind, that's you, not your
horse. I have just an innocuous question here. Who has the heart?
Well, wait, the heart?
Yeah.
Heart the first thing we found.
Oh, that's actually right, that's right.
Laura?
Ed has it.
Ed has the heart?
I don't know why people keep letting the morally shifty characters take evil artifacts, but Laura, you know.
It's because you're all shifty characters.
To be fair, I was holding on to it for someone. Yes, the right kind of evil person, you know.
Gee, I wonder who that could be.
Say, what were you gonna say, Emmy?
Does Laura have the heart?
If Ben got to it first, and you want to talk Ben out of having the heart.
Wait, no, I have it.
Or not Ben, I mean, I meant Ed. Come on. This thing is not dragging out.
The heart is mine. My precious.
Oh, come on.
And then it gets real weird.
Just hold on, everybody. Oh, there we go. I think that might have done it. Yes.
I don't know if Laura would have allowed Ed to have the heart.
It feels a little late to try to retcon it, right? Moving forward, if we want to have that conversation, but like, I feel like for safety, let's just say somebody has the heart.
Okay.
Okay.
And... why is she, speaking of Laura, she's not on the thing.
Yeah, she's actually missing. Her and beautiful assistant decided to walk.
She's gonna get on the horse and beautiful assistant.
Baby Toe Kid's back.
Oh wait, beautiful assistant's with Declan.
I like the idea that in this universe Toe Kid is Groot and is baby Toe Kid.
Okay, so out of the sky, a giant dragon-like creature swoops down, just making a dive bomb right towards Ed. This is going to get real hairy, folks. So hang on to your butts.
Don't worry. It's probably an illusion.
It's fine.
Everybody roll for initiative.
It's always fine.
Don't worry, guys. The DM wouldn't TPK us now.
I would. I didn't have my guy selected. Hold on.
It's like a cliffhanger. You kill everyone.
This is an Infinity Wars, damn it.
See, when I roll for Thokan, he gets good initiative.
Yeah, that's because it's not me. Pulling the. It has nothing to do with Thokan. This is every game I play.
Okay.
It's pretty much true.
Declan, you're first. You're gaining on Thokan, you're on a light, you're on a riding horse, so you can move at extreme speeds, but there's also...
Just throwing it out there, unless I cannot use my cunning action to dash, I'm probably faster on foot. Because if I dash, my movement speed is 70 feet. If I bonus action dash, my movement speed's 105, I think.
I think your horse can move at 120. Okay.
Yeah.
So
I got 150.
So your horse is good. Dokan's horse probably moves a little bit faster. I don't know what the... Do paladin's horses get bonuses to speed?
Oh, yeah. Has he not been responding to my shouts? Or
he has not been responding to your shouts. He seems to be trying to get away.
If I remember correctly, I don't remember exactly what it is, but yeah, the paladin warhorse is stupidly fast.
Yeah. Well, he is definitely something. Anyway. Okay, so, Declan, what are you going to do? He is ignoring you. He is riding into the distance. He's saying he just finished blowing the horn, and he put it back into his saddlebag, and he looks back and watches as it swoops down towards Ed.
I'm going to, like, shrug at him, like, what the fuck, dude? And then I'm going to take a shot at his horse.
Okay.
But miss, apparently, so. Unless, I'm assuming I wasn't hidden in any fashion.
No. No.
Okay. That's it for me. I'll just keep chasing him.
I'd like to see how you could be hidden when you're, like, charging after him shouting.
Well, just, you know, if I'm more than 100 feet away, his vision wouldn't, you know, that kind of a thing.
Sneak attack! Hidden.
Okay, it is his turn. He's going to move, like, freaking a million D feet. Many. It's your
chase. We could use the feet. The, you know, chase lanes or whatever.
Yeah, I really hope you don't try to take down this guy, this though can. But you can. You could try.
So the thing is attacking Ed.
Yes.
I don't think I have anything left.
It's dive bombing. It is, it's in striking distance somehow because of the rules of D&D.
Can I just, like, ride past it with my horse and poop it?
Yeah. So it's coming down towards Ed, and you ride past on your horse, and you can boop it. Okay. You... actually boop it.
She's just like holding her staff out as she rides at the horse because she doesn't.
Yeah, you like clothesline it.
If I'm not back up, I'm just gonna shoot my longbow.
And it Okay, it is Laura's turn.
Okay.
Was that just you chugging potions, Declan?
Over the course of the time that it's probably between
Hey, who has that flesh to stone thing?
Me.
Ed.
Okay.
Oh, hey. Just use that. Problem solved.
I don't really know where that would be, but... Laura's gonna shout, "Hey, flesh to stone!"
make that a cool statue.
Make a grandfather statue, and she's also going to ride up. And so this is not a reasonable request. However, rule of cool says that Laura would also. I imagine this is like a desert that they're running in. They're riding in, which
it's,
makes the napkin.
It's a
jungle, right?
It's a jungle that's been cut down.
Can Laura try to jump onto the back of the dragon thing, or the wyvern, or whatever, but it not use up her ability to attack?
Yeah, if you make a, if you basically grapple it, Well, grappling normally takes one of your actions. So yeah, I would say so
grappling is an attack.
Yeah, it would take up one of your attacks. So you could grapple it and get on top of it.
Okay. This is... Oh, I wish I had inspiration.
It is technically one size larger than you, so it is in that range.
And so, it just has advantage.
Which gives it advantage on grapples?
Yes.
I think?
Yeah. It's advantage.
Beautiful assistant, though, right?
She does. Beautiful assistant's gonna give her emotional support. She is going to do that stupid thing that is not a very good idea. Like some kind of... I think it's a... Oh, God. Yeah, no. That wouldn't have been even possible because she couldn't match it.
Okay. By the way, Laura, you noticed that this wyvern... I don't know if this matters to you, but it's undead. So that's just a thing I want to throw out there as you're kind of doing your stuff, as you're getting onto it.
Oh, but she...
Oh, boy. Ketchup wizards.
Wait, does she... As she's getting onto the... Like, as she's successfully getting onto the wyvern with a 11 athletics?
No, but you were trying to climb onto it, and you notice, like, some skin sloughed off. So it seems to be undead.
Oh, that's probably what made it not work.
Yeah, it was so slippery from the slippery falling off skin.
Okay, let's try this a second time, actually.
Okay.
That's a 12. It's probably got like over 5 as the bonus.
It's got 4. Okay, you're on the wyvern. Now, since you didn't take one attack action, I don't think you get your offhand attack, but...
She doesn't.
You do. You are on the wyvern.
Also, does she take ouchie damage from jumping off a horse?
No, because I like the style. So you're on the wyvern now. You're holding around its neck, and it's flailing. It's still flapping in the air. It is going to attack Ed. It seems to want to kill Ed. It rakes its wings forward towards Ed's face and tries to claw at it, but it misses. But then it whips its tail back, a vicious stinger sitting on it. Does a 13 hit you? Okay. Take that 34 damage.
Oh my god.
Ow. I'm down.
And it grabs your pack off of your back.
Can you not cut words as a bard?
I don't have that.
It's
a lore bard ability.
It rips the pack off of your back and it begins to fly away. Many, you can have an attack of opportunity as it flaps 80 feet in the air.
Pew. Oh no.
Oh god, I wish I had a spell slot.
Me too.
Taking more Lightwind with her.
Yes. Okay, Seabolt.
Seabolt, oh god. How high up is it?
They're 80 feet up.
Okay.
You could take the bracelet. Do it.
Oh, it does have the backpack in its... Well, I don't know if the bracelet would be in the backpack, but yeah.
Bracelet was on me.
You know what? You know what?
He put it on, like, immediately.
Let's
require attunement, though.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Actually, are there any items that don't require attunement?
Tons. Your sword.
Harmony and the eagle whistle, I believe, doesn't.
Nope.
Okay.
Yeah, where's that whistle?
The whistle's with Beautiful Assistant. Is Beautiful
whistle,
Assistant with you?
No, oh. No, the whistle is mine. No.
Oh, right.
Beautiful Assistant having the whistle. That would be ridiculous.
Okay.
Oh. So he's not able to make any attacks. He's just going to ride up.
So it'd be like when Momo blows the Oppa whistle.
He's going to follow.
Okay. So everybody's following, and it's Ben's turn. Ben?
How high?
80 feet. It flies faster than you.
Oh, it's trying to get away?
It's trying to get away. It's got the backpack. It's got Ed's backpack in one of its claws.
I'm gonna fly after it and make it 30 feet.
Okay.
And I'm gonna start shooting.
Okay. You're pretty versatile with that Kensei bow. That's pretty cool. All right.
Ignore the second four. Only the first four counts.
Got it.
20.
Yep.
That's pretty good stuff. All right. It's actually, you know, it's a very powerful monster, but you're doing pretty good considering. Ed, can you make a death saving throw?
Yes.
Roll 20. I guess that's awesome. Okay. It is Maeve's turn.
Indeed it is. And I am going to spend my inspiration that I've been saving this whole time so that I can try to shoot it with my hand crossbow because I have walloping bolts.
Okay.
We have the same idea.
So, 16.
All right. 16, it does hit. And... So walloping makes it go prone, right?
Yes. It does have to succeed against the strength.
Strength save.
It does have good strength. It makes it.
Sadly,
it's a dragon.
It's not a dragon. Oh, it is a dragon. It's just a wyvern.
I was going to assume, does that thing have enough strength for a freaking arrow?
Declan, I mean, give it a shot if you're going to do it.
So which direction was Thokan riding off in?
Thokan was riding off, let's say, in the map, cardinal map direction, southeast. Yeah.
Okay. And this creature seems to be heading the same way?
It does.
Okay. Then it's heading towards me, because I was 120 feet following Thokan, so...
I think you're in range. I mean, especially with
we can't represent that on the map, obviously, but
yeah.
I guess I'm... all the fucking way down here.
Well, if you do calculus.
Yeah.
I mean, it was trying to get altitude before it was trying to get... I mean, it would have, you know, it could have gone diagonally, I guess, but its primary, you know, goal was to get altitude.
Is it fair to say this thing doesn't know where I am?
The Wyvern or Thokan?
The Wyvern's 120 feet away from me.
Yeah, I would say so.
Let me roll that just in case. All right. 19's the best. This is with
it does hit
ammo.
Okay.
And then
oof.
It does fail
its strength save and begins to plummet with Laura on its back.
I think aims down range at Thokan one more time and sees him kind of turn into dust, and then he's like, whoa, over his shoulder and turns around and sees
so how fast? So we did falling rules before. Can we do our physics check? So if it's falling as
it's hundreds of feet in a round. It's hitting the dirt.
Okay.
The next 6 seconds or 7 seconds, it's landing on the ground.
Okay. That's pretty baller. Thokan continues to ride away. He's getting far into the horizon now. And Menier's turn.
She's gonna look at Ed, and she's gonna look at Laura. She's gonna look at Ed. She's gonna look at Laura, and she's gonna blow her whistle, and then go try and catch Laura, which is gonna end terribly because she's tiny and not strong.
How fast do you fly?
50 feet.
Okay, so you could kind of fly underneath it and try to make a grab. So as it's falling down, you grab Laura out of the air, and. Like off of its back as it's falling, and it tries to like lash at you. Oof. So wait a sec. So would it get? I don't think it would get an attack of opportunity for falling. So it doesn't get you though. Just cinematically, it lashes at you, and you like barely get out of the way. and
you, like, blow the whistle extra hard.
Because yeah, like, and you're holding, like, Laura's holding on to your arm, and you're, like, just flying with the power of magic, but it's still heavy. Laura, it's your turn. As the wyvern is plummeting, you're, like, held aloft by this gnome in the air.
Oh, wait, she's in the air?
I feel like I'm just, like, slowing your fall, because I'm not strong.
It's like the most hilarious Superman theory ever.
Laura's not stupid enough to, like, let the to jump out of anybody's arms. So she is going to drop the fan and the sword, the lightning blade, and she is going to throw some cards.
At the wyvern that's falling? The second...
Yeah, well, they're probably going to all land in the dust because she wants to kill the... Actually, you know, it makes no sense that she's going to throw cards.
Why not?
She's gonna... I don't know. She's going to use a... sitting in the arms of a gnome. Thank you, gnome. My gnome friend.
Because she's just, like, holding on to one... with both hands and, like, blowing frantically on this whistle.
So the wyvern hits the dirt. It takes 8d6 damage. It takes 23 damage.
Oh, man. Laura totally would have survived that.
I was so afraid.
The right thing.
And Seabolt, you're nearby. The wyvern gets up, and it is going to try to take flight again without Laura. It can only move half of its speed, so it gets 40 feet into the air and continues.
Laura is holding a lightning blade.
Okay, so you're going to try to do attack of opportunity?
Oh, wait, no, she's not on the ground. Sorry, I forgot about that.
Okay. So it flies 40 feet diagonally, and it is, so it's 40 feet up, 40 feet away. Seabolt.
40 feet up, you say?
Yeah. Its fly speed is 80, so it only got half of its speed. I don't even know if we're playing real D&D right now with my Calvin Ball-esque rules, but I'm trying.
I think it would matter if we were playing Adventurers League, but we're not. Fuck it.
Seabolt's going to throw his his hand axe.
Okay, so you're gonna have disadvantage. The 10 misses. Yeah, so it just falls to the dirt and sticking out of the muddy, like, ruined jungle ground. Ben.
About 50 up.
Yeah, I think you can make it there. So with a diagonal flight.
Over here.
Just get the bag. I'll
go, like, right there.
Alright, yeah, so you block the wyvern's path. You're just facing off with it. What are you going to do?
Keep hitting it.
Alright.
See if it stops.
Are you dropping your bow and pulling out the hate stick, or are you just doing...
Yeah, I'm just gonna drop the bow and pop the stick.
Okay.
Make it drop the bow.
Oh, gee. Oh, wow.
Oh, boy.
Shit.
What the fuck are you doing?
Is it a witch?
Can I get a total, y'all?
So is it all four attacks, or is it just the first three?
All four.
Yeah, it's
damage. It looked like
you punch it. So, like, with you're just punching and kicking. Like, it's like Dragon Ball Z when their fists just blur, you know, and it's just like there's just like a million punches going into it, and the stick is just like, yeah, fuck it in its fucking dragon face, and it's just and it's just
so pissed about not being gold laced anymore.
And it just, it dies. You kill, you crush this wyvern to bits. You pulp this wyvern. And the so-called paladin rides off and is gone. You can't see him anymore. You don't know exactly where he went. The hoof trail is still there, but it's...
I like to imagine that Maeve is just happens to be riding past as the wyvern falls and just grabs the pack.
Yeah. And that is pretty much, I mean, I know we started late, but we could keep going, but I don't know if there's much more fighting or excitement than that. It was pretty cool.
That's just off in the direction he was moving, which obviously is disadvantage.
Yeah. And it doesn't hit.
I'm gonna land and then go help Ed.
Okay.
Wait, Ed doesn't need your help. Ed is going to live.
Sorry that you went down, Nakore. It's just, it was for the story. So it actually worked out in a really fun way. I mean, I would have been fine.
We're flying enemies. We've learned this.
I would have been fine
I just need to go to town, get some plate armor, and then not care.
I would have been fine if the wyvern had...
Yeah, he is a level player.
Oh, that's fancy.
Yeah, if the wyvern had gotten away, that would have been fun. If not, it still was fun. It's it's a good time. I just pulled that out of my ass. I hadn't thought of that at all before we started. So
yeah, I'm gonna ride up to the dead wyvern and I'm gonna rip the sack out of its claws. And I'm going to turn to Laura, and I'm going to toss the pack over
Maeve,
to...
Maeve already grabbed it.
Okay. Then I'm going to ride up to Maeve, and I'm going to take the sack out of her hands. And I'm going to turn it over to Laura.
Give you the sack, because she's already transferred the heart.
That's fine. I don't know that when I ride up. Can I have a narrative second, please?
Yes.
No, I grab the backpack, and I throw it at Laura. Like, obviously, she's too far away to get hit by it. But I just throw it in her direction. Grandfather's a fucking asshole.
Yeah.
I'm like bleeding out. I'm
bag. Patting at your wound.
What the hell happened to him?
I'm trying to fix you. He'll be okay.
Dragon.
He got jumped by a dragon.
It's okay. He's dead.
Yeah, but we lost the eye.
For now.
He told us where he was going, maybe. Unless it was a lie. But he didn't seem that bright.
We could try to track him, but we're beat to shit.
Yeah, I recommend that we get me some armor.
He said he was going to Silvery Moon. So we should go to Silvery Moon and get Ed some armor so he doesn't die.
Laura's going to also, there's move magic, to Ed so, oh, wait, you're healed and already. Take back her gloves.
So yeah, you don't have like a calculation for a portal to Silvery Moon. So it is a long. Is that where you're going? Do you want me to do the time passes thing?
I mean, I'd like to take a look at the wyvern. Can I tell that it's undead?
Yes, you can tell that it's undead.
Is it intact other than being undead? Or is it like...
It is intact. Like a face? Yeah, it is intact. It seems to have a like a triangle branded into its forehead. And it's like an upside down triangle. And, you know, but other than that, it, you know that, well, none of you know anything, actually. You're all bad at knowing things. So
you're just talking about magic triangles.
Can I try to knock out its biggest teeth?
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. I mean, it did.
Survival or?
That would be, yeah, survival.
This is the second time I've fought an undead dragon.
You have a wyvern tooth. It's not in great condition. Can you believe that just one attack, that nice, ugh, just gotcha. Oof.
It won't happen a second time.
Ben is baller.
Okay. So yeah, do you want to do anything else here in Chult?
Rest.
Okay, so all of you are going to camp.
Chult.
Camp in the jungle, and I assume you're all healed.
At least the short rest, if nothing else.
Yeah,
you all... It's like the cleared out part of the jungle.
Well, it's going to be, you know, like a multi... Like, it's going to be like a month's journey at least to get to Silvery Moon.
Are there places in between?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's not... Yeah, let's do that. Let's not just go straight into whatever next...
Mm-hmm. Okay, so you take I'm sure you take a full rest. There's no real cities in Chult, you know. You don't know where anything is in Chult. You don't even know if you're in Chult, but that's kind of what you kind of pieced together.
Is there a clear enough path out of here? Do we just find one?
Because everything is cut down, you don't know, like, what has, you know, torn down the jungle. Something did. So it's really easy to find your way, you know, like, following the path of the sun. The only thing you know, does anybody have, like, a background, what is it called? Outlander?
A guide.
You're
guide.
A guide? Okay.
A guide.
So, yeah, you know that Chult, you know, like the north end of Chult, it goes towards Faerun. So you need to be on the north side of the peninsula to get back to the Sword Coast, essentially.
North side.
Okay, I'll lead everybody around and I'll point out like all the different plants and stuff and be like, "This is this plant. It does this. And this. It can be found in these regions."
Pull out like your Ranger Joe hat.
Yes, that's how I used to make a living. I know my shit.
Okay. You all head, and you feel kind of beaten because you just did all this work for this thing that was taken from you. And you almost had the other thing taken from you, too. And, you know, it's really kind of defeating. You know, does anybody have anything like they want to say or do? Because I can start fast forwarding us too if we want to.
I mean, I guess it depends on your, you know, what you mean by fast forward. Like, I wouldn't mind a little bit of downtime in like a town or a city or traveling or something like that if people want to close up loose ends.
Yeah, I was going to assume.
An hour role play.
I was going to assume that we do the city activities in Silvery Moon, but there's all sorts of places we could develop. We could come up with our own town. You could return to Strayed's Gallows. You're not in, you know, your home plane anymore, but you do have the ritual to get.
I assumed Silvery Moon might be evil now that somebody told us to go there and then attacked us with an undead dragon.
Yeah, you do have the ritual to get back to your home plane where Strayed's Gallows and I forgot the town that the master lived in were located. What did you say again, Jim?
Oh no, I was just saying like I just didn't want to fast forward into like, haha, Silvery Moon is evil, haha. Like if you're saying like no, Silvery Moon is safe.
Yeah.
That's the town that you guys are going to, then for sure.
Yeah, if that's where you want to go. I mean, this is the open world portion of our game, so you can go anywhere.
Is there like a map or
I can give you the map of Faerun if you want.
Okay. I mean, if we're just in Faerun, I guess I just want to let other people besides me, because I feel like I drive this into a wall. If anybody else
is... No, I mean, whenever a DM opens up open world, it's always kind of, you know, like, weird. But really, you can home base for a second in any place you want to in Faerun, and as long as you have the money to get transportation, which you do, you have money to get a ship from Chultz to anywhere.
I don't want to be on a ship. Or maybe I do. Ships can be fun. I get shinier stuff at some point.
Our ghostly companion is in need of weapons.
Okay.
He just threw away his hand axe.
He can find it again, can he?
I mean, I guess, but maybe a little bit difficult.
He doesn't wanna. Comb the desert.
Comb the desert.
We ain't found shit.
Yeah, no. Okay. So, does anybody have anything they want to do in Chultz? Or should we?
Do we want to get Scarlet Snowflower on the way, and she tries to?
I think she's dead.
Of love.
She's dead. Yeah. Unless somebody has something specific to Chultz, I think we'd charter something at least towards the mainland.
Charter a butt.
Charter that butt.
Oh, sure. Why not?
Does it cost anything to do that, or?
No, we get to charter a boat for free. Charters don't cost money. This is sarcasm.
Yeah, I mean, I will say that.
To be fair, we could just buy a boat.
I think you can just. We'll just say that you have enough money. I'm not even going to worry about you subtracting for that or for your food expenses, but after that we'll start tracking more stuff once we actually figure out how much money you actually have. Fair enough.
Yeah, I'm gonna this is my bad. I haven't gone through the entire thing yet. The biggest thing is tallying up the items that we need to be able to sell, since it's we can't just liquidate them.
Yeah.
And then we'll sell them silver, Amen.
Because, yeah, 20,000 silver pieces is only 2,000 gold, which is still a lot, but, you know. You guys aren't, like, stupid loaded. You just have a good haul for... Yeah,
a lot of little stuff that we found in the temple that we need to be able to sell, because it wasn't... You know, it was like you pick up a jade statue worth 15 gold.
Port Nyanzaru is the best place to liquidate that. You probably find when you get there. Because it's the best place to sell hard goods to traders from all over the nation.
As soon as this session's over, I'll go through the entire chat log. I'll grab every piece of loot, and I will liquidate that, unless there's something you think we couldn't sell there.
No. But yeah, so if you want, Port Nyanzaru is, I assume, where you're selling things. I have added the same magic item prices thing there. I would say... You know, obviously, like, no legendary stuff, but if anybody wanted to use all the money towards one thing, you probably could afford one or two things. And just especially since you guys just lost out on so many magic items in that dungeon.
Oh.
What?
Sob.
There's so many. So many.
Cry myself to sleep.
Oh, did we only find the bad ones?
No, you found...
We had those good and other ones that were kind of odd.
You found some good ones. There's just, you know...
I like the floating staff and the figurine that...
There was a wand of lightning bolts.
Oh, fuck.
Nothing big.
So, you know, there was some stuff like that. Okay, so you are in Silvery Moon, yes?
Sure. Yes.
Okay.
Well, I mean, the only thing that I'd like to get from the store is plate armor, if it could be done.
Yeah, I think what he's saying is, like, Silvery Moon is peaceful, so we can do our shopping here.
Yeah, it's not, this isn't, like, owned by zombies or something like that. That's what I was just trying to make sure you were aware of.
The zombies own it.
Is there a library?
Zombie landlord.
There is... Hold on. There is a library. It is the biggest wizard college in the country. It's not the biggest library. That would be Candlekeep. But it is it is probably the second largest library in the country.
At some point, I want to go read up on dragons and juvenile dragons and dragon eggs and things and try to not be super obvious about why I'm doing so.
Sure. So, yeah, this is where we're going to do some kind of, like, we're doing some planning actions. So, Janessa is going to, you gain access to the Wizard College. What do you tell them to, like, what are your credentials to go into the Wizard Library?
None. I am a guide, and I want to learn some of the lore in the area around dragons, and I was kind of, like, spice up my... storytelling, I suppose, with some factual details.
Okay.
How dragons are reared.
An elven woman named, let's see, Alia Tromyar. She looks at you and she says, I see. You don't look like a lot of gnomes that I've seen before.
What do you mean?
She pulls out like a magnifying glass and studies you and she says, You're extra planar. You're an outsider.
I suppose. Mm. I don't even know what you're talking about.
Interesting.
I'm not from here.
Well, there's nothing against outsiders being here, and in fact, we are about sharing knowledge, so I suppose you can study our dragon materials. That would be fine.
Oh, yay, thank you.
Just make sure that you wash your hands after you turn every page.
Oh, definitely. Yep, I am... all about that.
All right.
I'll just like now.
Who else wants to do something in Silvery Moon?
Can I be at the library with her?
Sure.
When she walks off, I'm going to lean into the librarian and be like, she's modest, but she is a student of Alarad Dawnforge. Someone you should be very familiar with.
She looks like scandalized. She's like, oh.
Whatever she wants. You give it to her.
She like
I
is like
to speak to your archivist in that room over there, and I pointed just a small room with no windows.
She says, I don't want anything to do with that man. And I would suggest you don't suggest you don't mention him again if you want anything in the city.
Oh, Maeve is gonna hear that and she's gonna be like, Who's this? Alarmad?
He has a complex history with the college. Let's just put it that way.
Who do you think's trying to stop him?
I have nothing better to do than
to stop.
I'm just trying to basically bullshit my way into higher access.
To stop Alarad?
Yeah, him and his friends.
Is he still alive? We haven't heard from him in a long time.
You run a wizard's college and you think death can stop someone like that.
I think you're right. I mean, it wouldn't make much sense. You should talk, yes, to our archivist. She knows Alarad better than I do and could probably give you more information about him and his friends. And we cut to Laura. Did you want to do anything?
I'm still thinking. So right now Laura is most interested in, I would say she wants to find the man in dark armor. which is now his official title is the Man in Dark Armor, rather than SoCam. And she wants to learn about Death Knights.
Okay.
And potentially, like, their weaknesses and stuff. But I also feel like everybody else is at the library. Laura is gonna get... I don't know what happens with Laura. I'm gonna think more.
All right. So, Maeve, did you want to do anything in Silvery Moon at all?
I want to ask the librarian lady if they have any kind of anything with pictures, because I can't read.
Yes, we have a whole art section. We also have an adult reading course.
I was honestly hoping that it's like, oh yes, we have children's picture books if you want those too.
Do you have any picture books of magic? I'm an accomplished mage.
Wow, fascinating. You learned magic without being able to read?
Yes.
Are you a...
Me.
Are you a sorcerer?
And I cast minor illusion, and I cast like a minor illusion of like a spider walking across the desk.
She says,
But it's like the spider that many turns into.
Hmm. I see. Drow magic. Interesting.
I'm gonna like tug on her sleeve, and I'm gonna be like, what's a drow?
A drow is... Well, if you mentioned the master, as he called himself... That's,
No, I was pretending not to know who that was.
Oh. Then, it would be bad elves.
Oh.
So that means the white
ones,
right?
I only know one elf, and I think he's good.
Yes, the...
He's also dying. Oh, wait, he's not dying anymore. He got fixed.
cut to yelling from the enclosed room. I think he's good.
Rob, did you want to do anything in Silvery Moon? There's pretty much, like, Silvery Moon's one of the few places where you can buy, like, high-quality magic items, pretty much as many potions as you want. You don't have to just shop. You can information seek as well, like the others.
Bird brand, probably looking for a staff of striking and then staring sadly as he realizes it's 21,000 gold.
And the hate stick is like, what the fuck are you doing? Why are you looking at her like that? What do you think?
Whose number is that?
What, you think she's all that, huh?
Whose
she can
number is that?
You're just like at the store. The magic item seller is like, oh yes, I'm sorry, I can't let this one go for what you have on you, but you know, it's the only one here. The prices have gone sky high ever since we stopped being able to trade magic items with Thay.
How much do we have?
We don't know the exact amount right now, but
it's
we'll
some
have...
amount like 600, 700 or something.
No, you'll have probably somewhere around 5,000 to something like that.
Well, just me.
Oh, yeah, we have those fish scales and stuff too. Those are probably worth.
Yeah, there's the thing is, there's just a bunch of trinkets. But like when I knocked out the teeth of that, whatever the fuck it was underneath the original smiling jester, there was that note of like, you can mark it down, but just realize you need to be able to sell things in a specific place in order to get their value. So like I've got a list of the coin money we've been handed, which everybody is up to date on. Except for today, obviously. But there's also a list that I'm compiling of like shit that we need to sell. So I'll have that number added and divided by the end of tonight.
Cool.
Jesus, this stuff's expensive.
Yeah.
I mean, the uncommon magic items aren't so bad.
Guess we should do more looting in poison dungeons.
Surprisingly reasonable.
Are we using that same magical prices thing?
Yeah, I mean, yeah. Some of them can make you pretty OP, but I think it's fine.
All of them are above my budget. They're all above 1,000 except for the simple ones.
Well, you know, it's something to think about for later.
Yeah.
It's the only one that is that actually is, well, sane, as it says. So.
Yes.
Okay. So, Nako Ray, did you want to do anything in Silvery Moon?
Besides get plate armor, yes, there is something I want to do. Since this is a magical place, I'm assuming that someone has some interest in some dark magic. And by dark magic, I mean a way to communicate with, you know, some devils.
Yeah, so in Silvery Moon, the dark magic isn't like super black markety or anything like that, but you definitely don't go like waving your arms around saying I'm doing dark magic. All magic is encouraged to be studied, but typically, like at the college, for instance, it's, you know, kind of all Hogwartsy, where it's just locked up, you know, like they want to know about it and know what they're up against, but they try not to use it.
They have a sign that says, please don't go here, and there's like a velvet rope that you can just duck under.
Yeah, exactly.
That's
so
basically how the restricted section was at Hogwarts.
So, but you basically find, you know, there's a guild of warlocks, you know, sorcerers, you know, and clerics that worship, you know, darker gods, things like that. And they what's the name of this? Does anybody have any good suggestions for the name of this? I don't want to call them a cult, but maybe like the
Fellowship of Not Do-Gooders.
So this is like a, what are they supposed to be?
They're seeking dark knowledge. So, you know, they're, I guess you could call them, let's call them the, I don't know. They're looking for power broking creatures like evil gods, you know, packed patrons, stuff like that.
They call them like Barovian Mist.
Advertise that they're bad people.
Right. So they're
I would say use something innocuous, right?
Like the truth tellers or something like that.
That could be like something they're actually looking for, or it could just be something people know about.
Okay.
Nightwish.
Great.
Oh,
band.
How I wish. So yeah, that's fine. They can be Barovian Mist. It sounds like a delicious whiskey.
Is good.
It's super innocuous. It could be a flavor of spirit. It could be the actual Barovian Mist.
So yeah. So and it's that's what it is. It's a it's a tavern.
I like that I could basically be walking past this place called the Barovian Mist. I can't read the sign. I'm carrying Strahd's heart in my backpack.
So it's a but there's a sign on the door. You know, it's Barovian Mist. You have basically been wandering around, like, you know, extracting information from people, and finally found it. Is there anything you want to know from them? Find out about.
I want to know if they have a ring that will allow me to communicate with my dark god.
And who is your dark god? Can we, we have a few different communication apparatuses for dark beings, but it just depends.
Now, is it more of a black morality or a dark gray god?
Sorry, we're going to need his area code.
Yeah, we do have
charcoal, maybe?
We do have, you know, a crystal ball for Cthulhu. I don't know if that would be useful to you or.
No, I'm going to do it the only way I know. I'm going to pull out my violin and just start singing a song about Asmodeus.
Okay,
alone, couldn't you use your awful bullshit?
The bar, yeah, I could. The bar starts like singing along, like in like a sea shanty style with you. Yeah, they're like, oh no, you can't get in touch with the King of Hell. No, he comes to you, man. Don't you know? Like, you don't go knocking on the King of Hell's door and be like, hey, can I have a cup of sugar? That's just not the way it works.
Damn.
But, you know, if you figure anything out, let us know. We'd love to ask him some questions.
Like what?
Like, what's his favorite color? You know, does, like, what does he look for in a companion? You know, like,
what's his perfect Sunday?
Yeah.
What kind of questions are those? I'd be like, hey, how can I bring the eternal flames of hell to this world?
I mean, no, like, what's his ideal first date, right? You know, like, something like that. Anyway, we're going to cut back to...
Hold on. Okay. Before that, now I'm going to use Word of Terror if we're just talking one-on-one.
Okay.
That's what I was waiting for.
Okay, what does the Word of Terror do again?
All right, you need to save a Wisdom saving throw or else you're terrified.
Okay. Let's say since he's a... I mean, we'll just give him a flat roll. So a 5. So... He is terrified. He runs off. He's like, oh God, you know him. You know. You're the devil's bride. The devil's bride is here.
Everyone in the bar is just looking at me. I'm like, I can play more.
So we go back to Jim and Janessa. So Declan, you're in the archive, and you see there's a few archivists there. A woman, so they're all women, but one in particular comes out. She is she's old, but she's very well preserved. She's not like hella old. She's like mid 40s, I think, maybe 50. Her hair is tied back with ribbons. She is wearing silk garments. She looks very familiar. It is the woman from the fortune-telling booth from before. She has dark, dark eyes and wears a small pair of spectacles. And she comes wandering over to you and she says, "Don't go throwing around Alarad's name here. You're going to get yourself in a lot of trouble."
I'm going to put the drawing that I have of Thokan that I've been working on for the last month on the table.
Okay.
Spin it around and slide it across the table and say, "Don't go sending me across planes and dimensions to do your goddamn dirty work."
She says, "Look, you saw him? Wait, you saw him? That can't be. You saw him?"
"I didn't say anything."
What is this supposed to mean?
"Who is he?"
"My husband." She looks kind of terse. She has terse lips. She says, I think it's time I told you everything. We haven't necessarily met in person, and this is an odd way to do it, but I think that you deserve to know, although we should probably have your friends here, and I'll tell you what I know. What happened?"
We don't tell that story yet. We pick a place and time. We'll meet somewhere with my friends,
mm-hmm.
but not here.
"Sure. Well, you could meet at my house, or if you'd rather somewhere public, we can do that too."
"I can send word. I will choose a place. I'll give you 12 hours notice. You can make sure it's safe. And that's where we'll meet."
"Okay. Well, it's good to meet you. Declan, right?"
"I never said that."
"I know." And she walks away.
Yeah, I just think I'm a boy and I stab him through the head with the drawing.
And so yeah. She definitely seems to know everything that goes on. Yeah, so Emiya, that was definitely Mimi, by the way. I think we all got that though. And I'm not role-playing all your characters correctly, but go ahead.
Actually, that was really...
No, I mean, that was honestly because there wasn't a window in the room for her to jump out of. That's as good as that's as good of a
Why?
Look, so
okay. Every witch needs to fall out of a window at least once.
Just because it wasn't a broom doesn't prove anything.
So Janessa, you're studying dragons. Wait, and oh, go ahead.
That, so that was like physical Mimi herself, not like a
no, that was the real
Aladian.
No, that was the real deal. That wasn't like a weird ventriloquist dummy or yep.
I was confused because the we haven't met in person thing is like so like she's a ghost version, a hologram.
Oh no, I mean she not before and. But that's the thing, is she seems to know everything that's happened to you, or at least that's what she's implying. So so anyway, Janessa, you're studying dragons, and you... I'm assuming you're looking at...
By the way, if I don't find anything particularly interesting, I'm just going to go hang out with Manny.
Okay.
And ask her about dragons.
Okay, so the two of you are looking at dragons. There are pictures in a couple of the books.
Yes!
And... Janessa, are you looking at how to hatch a dragon or something?
Yeah, like the incubation period and what they need and sure. How long it takes, and if I can tell like how far along the little baby dragon is inside.
It's not as difficult as you thought. Looks like you just need to rest the dragon egg on hot coals. It helps to be in a humid environment, or just to have like steam around, something like that.
Okay.
And other than that, you just have to.
Does the heat have to be constant?
It depends. Like you're looking at, you know, red dragon eggs, which are also fire dragons, have to, you know, be on constant heat. But there's not much on bronze dragons, which is, you know, what you've identified your egg is for sure.
Yep.
And so, yeah, I mean, but it seems like it should be the same, or brass, sorry. So it should be the same principle though. So just constant heat for about a month.
Okay. But if it's like not heated for a while, it's still fine.
Yeah. I mean, it's just like, it's going to take longer if it's kind of on and off heat, you know? And if it's off of heat for long enough, it needs to start the process all over again.
Right, okay. And then I want to read about, like, how to care for a baby dragon. Like, what okay. do they need to eat?
Yeah, baby dragons eat a lot. They eat their own body weight in raw meat every day.
Oh, Jesus.
What to know, what to expect when you're an expect dragon.
Maeve, this dragon's gonna need to eat a lot. A lot, a lot.
I'm a good hunter.
Oh, yay! I wonder
and
if...
You can turn into a spider and help.
That's true. I can turn into lots of stuff. Ooh, can I turn into
I like to imagine that this is one thing that Maeve is actually kind of getting a little bit excited about.
Yay!
She's dreaming of dragons.
Yeah, we could have... Oh no, we're not feeding the dragon good berries. How many good berries would it have to eat? Would it still just be one?
I don't know. Huh.
I feel like good berry might sustain it, but probably it would need to eat more to actually grow.
Yeah.
It would be super temperamental if eating good berries.
Good berries, it would be the
get
fat,
like one
little...
good berry, and it would be like
the idea is that you kill a chicken and stuff it with a good berry, and then it eats the chicken and is.
You'd be like, Mom, why do we have to be vegan still? I want to eat meat. Bad drink. Yeah, we just need to, like, have a home where we can...
Okay, you know what we need for Ed? We need demon armor.
Yes!
You hear in the distance, out an open window.
Yes!
He just pops up in the window.
Yeah!
Okay.
I think Emmy knows what she wants next time you do a cut.
Yes!
Get
if I can find it again.
So, I guess, is anybody else going back to where your friends are? Like, Rob, are you doing anything?
Laura wants to do a thing.
I got nothing.
Spence, can you hear Emmy?
Yeah, what did you want to do, Emmy?
Okay, so Laura has first thing that she wants to do is she needs to... She's gonna go find someone who, like, does magical item thingies. And she's like, oh, do you have anything that can make it so I can be underwater and not die? I had a recent pretty bad experience with... There was this mer girl, and she did something bad. She kissed me, and I couldn't breathe after that.
Oh, sometimes, you know, kisses do take my breath away, too. Oh, you took my joke? Why did you take my joke? Yeah, we do... I mean, we do have potions of water breathing. You know,
I'm looking for a more permanent solution.
There's a cellar in town that has a large shop that doesn't sell any weapons, mostly random trinkets with magical effects. Some of them are sanctioned because they are items from Thay, but, you know, I'm sure he's trying to sell them quick. And as long as you don't go waving them around, I don't think anybody will arrest you for having them.
So as an out-of-character clarification, what I want is a cap of water breathing. But okay. Hopefully instead of being a cap, it can be a scarf.
Well, yeah.
So then she can still have her hat on her head.
Typically getting custom magic items, again, that would have had to be the Thayan, since they were the ones that could create them most successfully. But I suppose, you know, there'd probably be a few water-breathing items, kind of as you're describing there. It might be something that matches your fancy.
This Thayan, what exactly is it?
Thay is a country. And they are powerful wizards that have learned how to bind dark energy into items. They have been in a lot of trouble. They've tried to conquer various cities in Faerun before. They also are known to be led by liches. So, you know, if that doesn't tell you enough, there you go.
Let's see.
They have taken control of the Zhentarim, one of the more powerful factions in the country. I'm surprised you don't know any of this.
Holy fuck! The Zhentarim are now controlled by the Thay. Oh, well, that's a problem.
Also, where would I go if I want to make a seance?
A seance? Well, you would need to... our teacher of divination in the school knows the most about seances. I thought I saw her wandering around, but you never know with her. Her name is Mimi. She's very good at speaking with the dead.
So Laura was like drinking water or something, and then she like chokes on her water. And she's like, wait, what? She's here?
Yeah. She's been teaching here for about 300 years.
I should have known that. Why didn't I know that?
She was an adventurer a long time ago. Did you know her back when she used to... She hasn't left Silvery Moon in a long time. Not that I know of.
Do I look like someone who's 300 years old?
I mean, you never know when somebody is, you know...
In disguise.
Or, you know, magically lifeless. Not lifeless. Lifelong. Yes, that's the one.
My name is Laura Lightwind. I'm actually her granddaughter.
It's nice to meet you.
Sort of.
She holds up her... This is the librarian, right?
I guess so.
She holds up her magnifying glass again. She says, another outsider. Interesting. Well, are you with the others?
The others?
Yes, the elf and the gnome and that one tiefling that can't read.
I'm not a tiefling. I'm just a human.
And that other, that creepy child that can't read.
Right, yes. Those are my thoughts.
Laura's like, oh, yeah, definitely.
Lastly, where can I learn about love?
Well, there's a red light district in town.
don't just pretend like nobody's laughing and pursue this. Just go.
I mean,
I don't think that's what I'm looking for.
Okay. I mean, there are many books. We have a whole art section. There's many books on poetry and bardic tales of love, you know, ancient stories of heroes saving their beloveds.
I'll go check out some of those, I guess.
I'm sorry, I can't be of more help to you. I hope, were you coming on to me? Is that what this was? Or, because I'm
no,
married,
not at all.
So, okay. Just making sure. Just checking. Flattered, though. Anyway, does anybody else want to piece anything together? Because I want to do a wrap-up soon and maybe do the exposition. I don't know. Unless you want to save that for tomorrow or next time.
I want to buy stuff, but I don't know what I want to buy. Because I don't know how much money I have.
We will get to that next time, then.
Okie dokie.
It'll be the shopping trip time.
Yeah, shopping episode.
Yeah, I mean, are you all getting back together at some point? Because Nakoray might just be hanging out with the evil kids, the goth at the goth bar.
If I can find some devil armor, it might be cursed. It might not be. I don't know. That'd be cool.
Oh, you want cursed armor? Of course. Yeah, I can. I can hook you up. Yeah, so it just depends, because you may not have, we may need to figure out your gold tally first.
There are no prices for first items.
1 million gold. I'd assume they'd be worse.
I mean, I can definitely...
Demon armor is a very situational curse. It's actually really good. It's like +1 or +2 plate.
Demon armor?
I'm pretty sure, yes. Isn't that like a legendary, or it's not legendary, but it's...
I think it's +1?
Oh, I'm gonna say.
Maybe, but it confers other benefits too, so...
I mean, I don't know. I didn't mean to open this big hole with giving you items you couldn't afford, but that's what
so
I did.
How much is demon armor?
I don't know.
I could use demon armor.
Really. You get nothing.
I don't know. I don't know what anything costs. I mean, I'm looking at this list. I can't find anything.
Yeah, I mean, the list was sent out. Stick to the prices on there. If it's not on there, pick something similar.
There is an alphabetized list of everything at the back.
Oh, right. Yeah, so there you go.
Yeah,
it's
good call, Claire.
It's in there. Demon armor isn't listed, or maybe it is and I don't see it, so
it's
not there.
They don't list cursed items. You can look at the very back to see what they did not list.
Good, there you go.
And why.
Good. Okay, anybody else?
Is listed as camping changer, because
so are weapons.
Oh.
Or no, weapons aren't, never mind. Yeah, well, I mean, they also list things like the alchemy jug, anything that grants flying, etc., as potential game changers, just because, you know.
I guess as a quick aside, Spence, would there be a mage I could find in the city that could send something back to the plane I came from?
It would be doable, yes. I mean, there is a contact other plane spell.
I'm essentially looking to pay for that.
Okay. Does anybody know if there is a material component for that? How much is... Oh, God, I wish I just knew how much spellcasting services were per level.
I don't think they have a flat one.
I mean, this is mostly flavor. I'm not sending a gun back to the year 1200.
I would just say it probably costs, like, 100 gold pieces.
Done. Okay.
Is that doable?
I'll fill you in on the details, but I'm looking for that service.
Okay. So you'll send me something?
Yeah, I'll send you a PM.
Okay. And anything else? Do you want me to do the meeting with Mimi this time? Because it could be long. I don't know how long it's going to take, because you may have questions.
It's up to everybody else. I'll be here.
There's quite a bit that I want to know about Laura before the meeting with Mimi.
Okay.
And I think that there's like some reactionings to happen.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I don't want it to just be casually, hey, you guys are now at Mimi's house. She has a bear. And also, you know, you're just casually talking like, so what was it like being a zombie for like 300 years?
Yeah, I think it's going to take a while. So let's call it here since we did good time. And
I have one last thing that I want to do.
Okay. Yes.
I don't know if everyone all right with if I send it just by like another 10 minutes.
No problem. Yeah.
Okay. I want to unmute my mic for this. Okay, the last thing that Laura is going to need is she needs to talk to someone about familiars. Someone who's not Mimi about familiars. Probably like a powerful mage. And stuff.
Yeah, no, there's like a master of familiars, you know, someone who knows like the whole history and lore about how they're created and stuff. Sure.
But it has to be the one who's not like the Raven Lord who has like 600 ravens or something, probably.
I don't know about that, but he's...
What's that called? Like ornithology? Like the study of birds? He's just like the magical ornithologist.
But he just, you know, he knows a lot about... That's all he studies. Like, he has, like, a PhD in familiars.
So, Laura wants to ask about... So, what she knows about this, about the familiar spell is that once the, if an animal were to stop being a familiar, then it would go away forever.
Yes.
And she wants to know how to break that without having the familiar go away forever.
I mean, it's been done before, but it's rare.
Can you tell me who did it?
Well, the only person that bragged about it very often was the master. He said he, you know, engorged his spider and set it free on the earth, but... None of us have ever seen it, so. But other than that, there's been other people. There's a couple mages in particular that, you know, have a special bond with more powerful creatures. You know, that's the only way to do that is to not have them linked to another plane. So I would say... you know, let me get you some materials here. You're likely going to need some special components for it. But yes, it's doable. I just don't think, I don't think a lot of people, you know, have the right materials or the power, level of power for it. Why are you so interested in this?
My friend, beautiful assistant, I'm worried that if I die while I'm on an adventure, you see, and I think I'm worried that if I die, beautiful assistant will be trapped in some pocket dimension forever.
I see.
And I'd rather he... I don't want my end to be his end
when it comes. Do you have any familiar with dimensional travel?
Or dimensional travel?
Are you familiar with dimensional travel? Do you have any spells that allow you to do that?
I don't have any spells for dimensional travel, but I... my companions and I have devised a way to move between worlds, sort of.
Well, that's phenomenal, yeah.
It requires this sword here that is in my sheath, and there's this fan. Well, it used to not be a fan, it used to be a sword of some kind. And, of course, there's other fancy things, blah, 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 describing how it's really cool and stuff, and Laura's super interested in it, but it takes a really long time to explain how the thing works.
Right, I mean...
blah, blah, blah.
But it sounds like, you know, you're doing some pretty advanced stuff, and I mean, if you don't mind me saying so, you don't look like a lifelong mage. You look like, I don't know, some sort of spellblade.
I'd prefer to call myself a stage magician.
I see. Well, I think that if you're able to go across dimensions, you may need something from your companion's home plane, something to bind. What if you bring it back with you, it would bind them here. You know, perhaps something it could wear, something like that, should allow it to stay anchored.
Tiny hat. That'd be ridiculous.
But you'd have to know, you know, what plane it comes from, which you can find out through study.
I actually know where he came from. He came from my home plane.
I see. Well, then it should be pretty easy to get something from there. You may have things on you. All you'd need to do is, you know, just invest time with your companion, make sure the item is bonded to your companion, and it should stay wherever you are.
Make sure to increase your friendship to max.
You do need to have maximum friendship. It's very important.
That's right.
Yep.
Make sure to get all 5 hearts on Pokemon and me.
A-rank. Yeah. Would it be for BFFs?
I don't remember. Before I came up with this idea on how to bind it, I didn't really think much that it would have come from somewhere you've already been. So it seems like you're already 2 steps ahead. You should be able to do that very easily.
Oh, wait, but out of character, he gave Laura materials, as in like reading materials?
Yes, or as in reading materials. Okay. Yes.
Okay.
So, go ahead.
During the probably like day of downtime we get, she's gonna totally study that.
Okay.
After the roleplay conversation has ended, or not ended, I don't know.
Yeah. Well, I can always count on you, Emiya, for making me pull stuff out of my butt. And that's what that was. So
raising.
So there we go. Anybody else have anything else?
I'll just send you the
the PM
contents of the note, but I'll wrap it up with the meeting spot so that you don't have to worry about that.
Okay, got it. I do have, this will give me some time to take a look at my notes on what I think happened and make sure that it all makes sense. So that'll happen next week. All right.
Next week!
Did anybody...
This is just a reminder, because everybody is here. We're going to play at probably 8:00. If you can't make it, let us know.
Yeah, if you let us know ahead of time, then we can...
Everybody will be here at 8 o'clock.
Yeah, if somebody can't make it, they can tell us ahead of time, and then we can either work around that, or we can, you know, go have lives. Either way, I like both things.
Yeah, I mean, I'll start trying to send out a message on Friday that is just a reminder, but, like, you guys know that we play on Sunday, so if you're not going to be available, today's an exception, it's Mother's Day. But, like, if you don't think you're going to be available, hit us up. Let us know in advance. We're not scrambling to figure shit out 2 hours in advance.
Yeah. The only thing for that is that I start work on Monday.
Okay.
I won't be able to stay up as late.
Okay. Well, if we start earlier, it will be less of an issue. But, for sure. You know, so if we're starting at, you know, even 7 your time, you know, that's even better for you. So
you start on Monday, you said? So you start tomorrow?
No, next Monday.
Okay.
The 21st.
So let's assume we're doing the same time and nothing has changed. You let us know how next Monday goes and we'll figure it out from there.
Okay. All right.
Okay. Cool.
Good night, guys.
Yeah, good night. GG.
Good night.
Have a good night.
How close are you to finish?